Chapter 466, Remnants of the Saint Ruler. That is true. I am still not sure who this person they wish for us to kill is. The newly named Elder Feng spoke. Who cares about his identity? Once we take the items from the cave, we will head over to the Jisung Kingdom. I am sure we will be able to find that Heaven Saint Master quickly. After saying that, the five Heaven Saint Masters began to descend down into the valley. Soon enough, they hovered 50 meters above the chilly waters and started to inspect the place. Take a look here, there's a cave. An elder pointed in a certain direction in amazement. Turning to look at the pointed direction, they discovered that there was a cave around 3 meters tall with a pitch dark entrance. Would it really be over there? Let's take a look. The five men simultaneously began to fly over to the entrance of the cave, arriving in the blink of an eye. Their surroundings were emitting a fierce energy that dragged them through the air. Do you sense that? The space here has a faint trace of the fire element. An elder stated with a frown, seeing the others agree with him. An elder whose body radiated with the fire element spoke as well. That's correct. The fire element is indeed floating around this area. While it is quite faint, I can still sense it clearly. I suspect there was another person here not too long ago. The scratches around the cave entrance are fresh as well. Someone has indeed beaten use to this place first. There aren't many that know of this cave. If we're going off of what the Kyangan Kingdom's expert said, then there is a powerful illusion array concealing the cave. If we didn't know the definite position, we would have never been able to discover the secret of the area. Unfortunately, just several days ago, the cave of the Saint Ruler was revealed to the individual from the Jisung Kingdom. It appears that the one who beat us here is undoubtedly that same person. When you say it that way, I agree with you. Now that that person is here, we won't need to waste any energy traveling to the Jisung Kingdom. We can just kill him here and accomplish the condition the Kyangan Kingdom expert had stipulated onto us. Very well then. Instead of entering the cave, the five continued to float where they were and began to chat. Since that man is already inside, we just have to wait outside. This way, we won't waste any energy dealing with the illusion array inside. If he is defeated by the array, then he'll be sent outside. If he overpowers the array, he'll still come back here eventually, giving us the chance to kill him. We can take the remnants of the Saint Ruler from him. It would save us all some energy. Within the hollowed out belly of the mountain was the cave of the Saint Ruler. It was quite dim and the air was damp, with only several dozen night pearls serving as faint light sources within the dark area. There weren't any trees or grass in the cave, and aside from the illusion array and the wooden house, there was absolutely nothing else. From this, it could be inferred that the owner of the cave did not care for the environment and instead only cared for the sake of his own cultivation. Jian Chen walked to the wooden house and began to look over it. The entire house was a dark color and felt as solid as tempered iron. Furthermore, he could sense that there was a considerable amount of energy flowing within the house. This energy clearly belonged to the existence that had lived within it for almost an eternity. At the very least, this house had stood for a thousand years through the corrosion of time, yet still remained in good condition. Jian Chen looked at the wooden house with confused eyes before gradually growing serious. After all, this was where a Saint Ruler expert had lived. Although Jian Chen was a Heaven Saint Master in strength, a Saint Ruler would still bring an unbelievable amount of pressure onto him. A Heaven Saint Master understood the energy of the world. That was the reason why they were so different from an Earth Saint Master. A Saint Ruler had already understood the mysteries of the world and could borrow their assistance of the world's power to create illusions that were hard to distinguish. Their strengths were such that they were many times greater than a Heaven Saint Master's. The difference between a Heaven Saint Master and a Saint Ruler was even larger than that of an Earth Saint Master and a Heaven Saint Master. The two ranks were worlds apart and could not be discussed together. Standing right outside the dark house, Jian Chen let out a sigh. Calming his heart of any emotions, he brought both his hands onto the ice-cold door and slowly pushed it open with all his strength. With a creaking sound, the doors began to open. The scenery inside appeared before Jian Chen's eyes. The very first thing that was visible to Jian Chen was a bed fashioned from iron along with a wooden table and a chair. From this, it could be seen that aside from the master of the house, There were no other guests. Inside the wooden house was a large abundance of energy that never seemed to fade. However, without entering the house, the existence of this massive energy would not be found. Perhaps it was because of this energy's existence that the inside of the house was extremely clean, as if someone swept it every day. Jian Chen walked into the wooden house and scanned around. It was rather ordinary looking. Its simplicity was not like that of a normal person's home. Aside from the table, chair, and bed, there was nothing else there. This house didn't have just one room. The place Jian Chen was blankly standing in right now was only the living room. In one of the corners, there was a single doorway that connected deeper into the house. Gingerly, Jian Chen walked inside the house. But the moment he pushed open the door, a surge of energy diffused outwards, the pressure making Jian Chen's body grow heavier as if he was carrying a large and heavy stone on his back. Under the tremendous pressure of this weight, Jian Chen felt as if he was a small sailboat in the ocean, insignificant and unable to defend himself. Jian Chen looked forward only to see a crystalline skeleton sitting in a cross-legged position on the bed. The energy from this saint ruler was many times stronger than the amount of energy he had felt back in the gathering of the mercenaries. The mere aftermath of the first layer of released energy made Jian Chen feel an extremely great pressure. One wouldn't think that this was the cause of a skeleton. It seems that he had not yet reached the ninth layer when he was alive, Jian Chen muttered in his heart. He was excited. Although it was only a skeleton, the energy within it was no weaker than a ruler armament. That to him was already a major profit, since the skeleton would be able to be processed for chaotic force through the sword spirits. This way, he would be able to use the chaotic force one day. Carefully walking up to the skeleton, which was still radiating pressure, Jian Chen slowly placed the skeleton into his space ring. After the saint ruler's skeleton had disappeared, the remaining pressure that was weighing down on him instantly disappeared without a trace. After successfully obtaining the saint ruler's skeleton, Jian Chen's heart couldn't help but beat rapidly in extreme excitement. No matter if it was the saint ruler's skeleton or ruler armament, it was still a priceless, rarely seen treasure on the Tianyuan continent. If someone were to grab hold of either one, then they would be able to ascend to even the heavens. A mediocre clan would rise up to become a great clan overnight. As for ruler armaments, they were viewed and kept as treasures passed down the clan members. Thus, it could be inferred that a ruler armament was no weaker than a saint ruler's skeleton. It had a high value as a treasure. After all, something like this could only be left behind by a saint ruler who had died. Afterward, Jian Chen discovered a silver space ring besides the empty spot where the skeleton used to be. The space ring didn't contain many things, most of them were hoarded items, but after rifling through it, Jian Chen found a single ancient scroll. The scroll was 2 meters in length and was yellow with age. However, it was still in perfect condition without any damage. Written on the scroll was plenty of words the size of tadpoles with just as many diagrams. Breathless, Jian Chen began to study the inner contents of the scroll with a face that revealed his excitement completely. This was a heaven tier battle skill, a middle heaven tier battle skill at that. Heaven Splitter. It used a strange method to circulate the saint force from within, compressing it. It could then be brought forth as an explosive energy to assault the enemies. Its range was quite expansive and could be controlled manually. Heaven Splitter was much different from any of the heaven tier battle skills Jian Chen was familiar with. All of the heaven tier battle skills Jian Chen knew of used saint weapons as their medium and burst out with powerful energy to assault their enemies. However, with the Heaven Splitter, one could use both hands to send out saint force to perform a ranged attack on the enemy as the user desired. Secondly, the ancient scroll mentioned that if a first cycle heaven saint master were to use Heaven Splitter, they would be able to easily destroy a mountain several hundred meters tall. From this, it could be determined that the battle skill was extremely strong. Jian Chen quelled the emotions raging within him as he put the Heaven Splitter scroll into his space ring. In his mind, he decided that the very first thing he would do when he returned home would be to give Heaven Splitter to Chang Wuji to learn. That was because Chang Wuji was the only Heaven Saint Master of the Qingyang clan. Having him learn it couldn't be more fitting. Plus, Chang Wuji had always been concerned with him and had silently served and protected the Qingyang clan for many years. As for the others that he was familiar with, Jian Chen would have to think about them another time. Qing Yangba's strength was still only at the Great Saint Master level, so he couldn't learn a Heaven Tier battle skill. One had to at least be an Earth Saint Master to learn a Heaven Tier battle skill. Aside from Heaven Splitter, Jian Chen had also discovered a Heaven Tier cultivation method. Although it was Heaven Tiered, cultivation methods were mediocre in comparison to battle skills. Both the Qingyang clan and Kargath Academy each had one. Despite that, Jian Chen didn't ignore it, since a powerful clan definitely wouldn't have just one type of cultivation method. Chapter 467, Meeting Elders Feng and Yun Once More. Aside from Heaven Splitter, Jian Chen had also discovered a Heaven Tier cultivation method. Although it was also Heaven Tier, cultivation methods were mediocre in comparison to battle skills. Both the Qingyang clan and Kargath Academy each had one. Despite that, Jian Chen hadn't ignored the cultivation method, since a powerful clan wouldn't have just one type of cultivation method. People could only learn a single cultivation method, but when it came to the power of a clan, it was best to have more than one to choose from. After all, not every cultivation method was suitable for everyone. There weren't many valuable things in the space ring left behind by the Saint Ruler. Not a single monster core or coin could be seen. They were probably left behind in the Qiangan Kingdom. Aside from the Heaven Tier battle skill and cultivation method, there wasn't any other item that interested Jian Chen. After he finished looking through the contents of the space ring, Jian Chen searched the entire house once more. But in the end, he didn't find anything out of the ordinary. However, he did find that after he had taken the Saint Ruler's skeleton, the energy that was accumulated within the house had disappeared. Although this house had been created from wood and steel, it would be impossible to stay within this damp cave forever. Without the Saint Ruler skeleton's energy backing it up, the moment the energy assimilated in the house was drained off, the thousand-year-old house would disappear from the world. Afterward, Jian Chen did one more sweep of the entire place. As there were still no profits to be found, he left the place. Leaving the area was much easier than entering it. The very moment he stepped into the illusion array, he felt the space within tremble before he was directly sent to the 3-meter in diameter, pitch-black passageway. Jian Chen took a deep breath before walking outside with a faint smile. In his heart, he thought, as expected, the Qiangan Kingdom didn't lie to me. There was truly a fully intact Saint Ruler's cave. Not only did I gain a Saint Ruler's skeleton containing great amounts of energy, I was able to receive a Heaven Tier battle skill and cultivation method. A bright light appeared in Jian Chen's line of vision. He quickly walked out of Saint Ruler's cave, arriving above the frigid lake at the bottom of the chilly valley. Just then, Jian Chen's expression suddenly changed. A light flared in his eyes, followed by a flash of pale cyan, as his body shifted 5 meters to the side. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. 5 ear-splitting sounds could be heard as 5 different strikes of sword qi came flying forward to bombard the spot Jian Chen had just stood in. The sword qi thundered down towards the center of the frigid lake, causing splashes everywhere. Jian Chen's face grew extremely unsightly. He abruptly lifted his head only to see that at some point, 5 figures had appeared above him. The 5 attacks just now had been sent out by them. The wind elements around Jian Chen's body suddenly became extremely powerful. His body shot up through the air like an arrow, leaving a mystical bow. "Don't let him get away," one of the 5 men had cried out. The 5 of them immediately formed a ring in the air to form a blockade in an attempt to seal off all of Jian Chen's possible escape paths. At the same time, 5 sword qi strikes were shot towards Jian Chen once more. Jian Chen's eyes revealed a bright glow as 5 separate swords made of fire formed around his chest. Then, they transformed into 5 furious dragons radiating intense, Scorching heat that collided with a sword chi bang. The sky burst out with a fierce explosive boom as the energy from the fire elements filled the entire sky and valley. The aftermath of the explosion rebounded off both the walls of the valley and fractured them into multiple spiderweb-like cracks. This continued to repeat until the cliff faces on both sides had countless large and thick cracks in them. The entire valley shuddered under the blow, causing several stones to fall off and drop into the cold waters below. Jian Chen charged upwards from below the cliff, not running away like the five Heaven Saint Masters had thought he would. Instead, he floated up to an equal level with them. "Who are you?" Jian Chen asked in a low voice. His eyes glowed brightly with a fierce killing intent toward the five as his gaze swept past the. However, when he looked to two of the men in the middle, his eyes suddenly widened with some shock. Jian Chen's mind suddenly thought back to several years ago right in front of Wake City. He had been washing himself carelessly when he had come across Huang Luan. Afterward, he had fought with the two strong individuals Huang Luan had called Uncle Feng and Uncle Yun. Weren't these two men right in front of him the same men from long ago? Despite the time that had passed since then, Jian Chen could still recognize them. "It's you. So it's you." The moment when Jian Chen had recognized the two elders recognized him as well. With their eyes largening in surprise, shock began to register across their faces. The other three men took notice of the shock on their faces. One of them quickly asked, "Elder Feng, Elder Yun, do you two know him?" Neither of the elders seemed to have heard the question and continued to look at Jian Chen with a quavering voice. One spoke, you stepped into the realm of the Heaven Saint Masters. At that moment, both of the elders' hearts were storming with emotions. When it came to Jian Chen, they were no stranger to him and had a deep impression of him. Because of their negligence in Wake City, a mere great saint had been able to steal a glance at their Huang Luan bathing. Their precious Huang Luan had been seen by a man for the very first time, and when they had struck out at Jian Chen, they had been injured by his azure and violet sword spirits. This had greatly shocked them. Afterward, during the gathering of the mercenaries half a year ago, they'd seen Jian Chen's display at the arena. At that time, it was extremely shocking to them. Before that time, Jian Chen had only been a great saint. They hadn't thought that in 4 years of time, Jian Chen would have risen at an unbelievable rate and become an Earth Saint Master. This type of strength was practically unheard of before. Plus, they had also heard from Huang Luan that Jian Chen had been tried during the gathering of the mercenaries. When the Solunar Bow of the Huang clan had nearly been stolen by the Shi family, it had been because of Jian Chen that the Solunar Bow had been preserved at the very last moment. Thus, Jian Chen had earned the ire of the powerful Shi family. And now, half a year later, Jian Chen had unexpectedly skyrocketed from being an Earth Saint Master to a Heaven Saint Master. An unbelievable speed like this left the two elders tongue-tied and heavy-hearted. "Elder Feng, Elder Yun, who is he? Do you two know him?" another person asked. The elders gave a sigh before slowly steeling their nerves. "He is Jian Chen. The very same Jian Chen that turned the number one spot in the gathering of the mercenaries." "What? He is Jian Chen?" Hearing that, the other three men revealed looks of shock as they again shifted their gazes back at Jian Chen. Those who participated within the gathering of the mercenaries had to be below 50 years old in age. If Jian Chen had participated in that, then he was no doubt younger than that. By this point, it had only been half a year since the gathering of the mercenaries. Having said that, this meant that the youth in front of them had reached the Heaven Saint Master realm before the age of 50. Within the Tianyuan continent, a progress speed as fast as this could only mean that he was an unparalleled genius. "Jian Chen, why are you here?" Elder Yun asked in surprise. Jian Chen stared at everyone with a blank expression. "Such a phrase like that should be asked by me. Why are you here, and why act against me just now?" Hearing this, Elder Yun's gaze moved to the entrance of the Saint Ruler's cave with a twinkling light. He quickly connected the dots, quietly spoke with a heavy expression. "I hadn't imagined that the person the Kai'angan Kingdom's Heaven Saint Master had been talking about was Jian Chen." Although the elder had spoken in a soft voice, Ji Yinchen had heard it clearly. His eyes began to blaze with a fearsome glare as he asked, "Did Qianyan tell you the location of the Saint Ruler's cave?"
"Correct. A Heaven Saint Master from the Qiangan Kingdom had told us about the Saint Ruler's cave. In exchange, he told us to take the life of a certain person." The middle-aged man spoke without expression, but his gaze held a hint of a cold light as he looked at Ji Yinchen. Ji Yinchen's mouth quirked to form a cold smile as his glare dropped several degrees.
"I didn't think that the Qiangan Kingdom would deal such a hand. If they want you to kill someone, it is surely me."
"Correct." The same middle-aged man expressionlessly replied. Ji Yinchen looked at that man and asked, "Now that I am here, what will you do now?"
Anger filled the man's heart. He coldly snorted and said, "The promises our Huang family make must be fulfilled. No matter who you are, you will not leave today."
"No." Elder Yun and Elder Feng cried out, "Ji Yinchen has been a benefactor to our Huang family. If not for him, our Solunar bow would have been stolen by the Shi family. Furthermore, he has saved the life of our young miss."
"Elder Yun, that is only the miss side of the story. We don't know what happened in that isolated space during the tournament where we cannot differentiate between falsity and truth. Who knows whether or not the young miss words are true?"
The middle-aged man fired back in argument.
"Then surely Shi Xiangren's death must be true to you."
Elder Feng replied, clearly on Ji Yinchen's side.
"And what can Shi Xiangren's death prove?"
"It doesn't say for sure whether there were personal feelings of gratitude or resentment between Ji Yinchen and Shi Xiangren," the man justified. The two elders glanced at each other, the expressions turning extremely ugly. After realizing that their target was Ji Yinchen, the two had a change of plans. Even if they were to brave the aftermath of damaging their clan's reputation, they didn't wish to make a move against Ji Yinchen. Not only was he a genius, but he had been a benefactor to their family. This was more than enough for the two elders to do so. Furthermore, he and Huang Luan had a strange sort of connection between them. However, their wishes did not speak for the entire group. The middle-aged man's attitude, in particular, made it hard for them to act. Chapter 468, Retreat of the Huang Family. At that moment, one of the other elders observing the situation spoke, "Ji Yinchen, when you entered the Saint Ruler's cave, did you take any of the items in there?"
"Correct, I've taken the items within."
Ji Yinchen didn't hesitate to speak without any complaint. Although he was against five Heaven Saint Masters, he wasn't afraid.
"Then there's nothing else worth talking about. Everyone, let us kill him for the sake of our mission. The reputation of our Huang family cannot be harmed by something like this. Otherwise, if our patriarch finds fault, who will take the blame?" one of the men spoke. At the mention of their patriarch, the other four men showed startled looks on their faces. They must be afraid of him.
"Absolutely not. Ji Yinchen is a friend to our Huang family. If you continue to act in such a way, then the patriarch will definitely find fault within us. Our Huang family is not a family that would commit such an ingratitude to a friend."
Elder Feng spoke harshly. "I agree. The Solunar bow is extremely vital to our Huang family. Our patriarch personally bore witness to the gathering of the mercenaries and had even inquired the young miss for her side of the story. I'm sure that the young miss has already explained everything in detail to him. If not for Ji Yinchen's help, our Huang family would not have the Solunar bow anymore. It is for that reason that Ji Yinchen is our benefactor. If you wish to continue to fulfill the mission from the Qiangan Kingdom, then our Huang family will truly be known as one who violates justice. Our patriarch would not forgive us for this."
"Elder Yun, Elder Feng, you two need not try to frighten me. I've already said before, the young miss may not be speaking the truth." The middle-aged man asserted his thoughts without relenting.
"Huang Jinren, Huang He, what are your thoughts on this matter?"
Elder Feng asked the two other impartial men. The two elders went silent for a moment before Huang Jinren spoke up.
"Elder Feng, Elder Yan, Elder Yan, the three of you speak with reason, but the items within the Saint Ruler's cave are of extreme importance to us and thus we cannot afford to let them go.
Ji Yinchen, how about this? You give us the items you found in the cave and we will not make things difficult for you.
We don't require much.
Just the Saint Ruler's skeleton will do. A single Saint Ruler's skeleton at the fifth layer is something that our patriarch has a great use for. Elder Huang He spoke. If they could bring back the skeleton, the strength of their patriarch would increase several times over, while the rest of the items in it were essentially dispensable. Their Huang family had a clear idea of how strong the Saint Ruler who had lived in the cave along with what his identity was, so they didn't think that there would be any other item worth their notice. Hearing these two speak, Ji and Chen gave a cold smile. You should give up on such a notion. The skeleton of the Saint Ruler will not be given to you. Ji and Chen, you should learn to accept a toast when it is given to you. Don't think that becoming the King of Mercenaries has given you power beyond belief. To the Huang family, if we want to kill you, it would be as easy as squashing an ant. The middle-aged man spoke dangerously. Jian Chen's face grew dark as the sheen in his eyes grew colder. With a terrifying and malicious glare, Jian Chen spoke to the middle-aged man, then do you think that I, Jian Chen, will kill you with the very same ease of stepping on an ant? How shameful, you will die here. The man's temper was clearly quite bad. He became infuriated by Jian Chen's stinging remarks. Immediately, he brought out his saint weapon and charged at Jian Chen. Jian Chen's hand clutched at the empty air, causing a sword made of the fire element to materialize. With a wave of his hand, the sword immediately shot toward the middle-aged man with a sweltering temperature. With a loud shout, the man's saint weapon came crashing down on the fire sword, causing an explosion. The fire sword was instantly disintegrated by the man's saint weapon and gave a final burst of fire that dyed the area red. The middle-aged man did not falter in speed. His saint force continued to protect his body from the sea of flames as he quickly arrived in front of Jian Chen. His sword was ready to pierce Jian Chen's chest. A layer of azure and violet light began to appear in Jian Chen's right hand before forming a 1.3 meter long glow. Grasping the origin energy of the sword spirits, Ji and Chen clashed weapons with the middle-aged man. There was a crisp sound as the middle-aged man's saint weapon chipped away to reveal a jagged piece of the saint weapon fall to the ground. With his saint weapon damaged, the middle-aged man's face suddenly blanched. A moment later, blood splattered out from his mouth. Hurriedly flying backward, the man looked at Ji and Chen in utter surprise. The moment when the two men had clashed was observed by the four other men. When the middle-aged man's sword tip had broke off, the other four couldn't help but feel their hearts leap wildly. The startling azure and violet glows of light in Jian Chen's hand were of an unknown energy to everyone. The middle-aged man flew 30 meters backward through the air before stabilizing himself. His pale face looked to the azure and violet ray of light in Jian Chen's hand before crying out, "What is that energy? Why is it so strong?" Jian Chen stared emotionlessly at the middle-aged man before speaking. "Fact of the matter is, if I wanted to kill you, it would be as easy as stomping on an ant. Right now, you have no chance of taking the Saint Ruler's skeleton from me." Despite being from the Huang family, the middle-aged man was trying to humiliate Jian Chen. There was no way he would easily forgive him. The middle-aged man had a sickening color to his face, but soon enough he looked back at Jian Chen with a renewed expression of fury. "The Saint Ruler's skeleton is extremely important to our patriarch. We cannot just let it go. Elders, let us three fight together to kill him." Huang Jinren and Huang He hesitated for a moment. In the previous moment, they hadn't thought of Jian Chen as anyone important. Although Jian Chen was a Heaven Saint Master, he was not a major threat to the Huang family. However, now that they had personally bore witness to Jian Chen's origin energy and its might, they could no longer look at Jian Chen in the same light as before. The origin energy of the azure and violet sword spirits could easily damage a Heaven Saint Master's saint weapon. That was an ultimate threat to their life. The tremendous power that Jian Chen controlled in his hand was enough for them to not offend him or even go against him as an enemy. "Fellow elders, what are you hesitating about? Could it be that you don't realize just how important the Saint Ruler's skeleton is for our patriarch?" the middle-aged man urged them. He didn't dare fight Jian Chen by himself. With that origin energy of Jian Chen, he was completely afraid of fighting him. "Elder Yan,
I think that this matter should be discussed with the Patriarch. Elder Yun and Elder Feng are correct in their words. Jian Chen has done a favor for our Huang family. We cannot conduct such a behavior toward him like this. Huang Jinren suddenly spoke, clearly not willing to be an enemy of Jian Chen's. That is right. I have that notion as well. Huang He spoke. The middle-aged man, now named Elder Yan, had a disbelieving look on his face as he stared at the two elders. He quickly realized that both elders had a change of plans and he instantly swallowed the fury in his unwilling heart. If the two elders did not fight with him as a three-man party against Jian Chen, there was no chance to win. If they didn't join him and he continued to fight alone, then he would be no opponent for Jian Chen. In the end, he would be the only one to eat a loss. Jian Chen, I, Yan Lai, will remember this. The man spat out. With that, he didn't even address the other four elders and quickly turned to leave the area. Huang Jinren and Huang He left the area as well without a word, leaving both Elder Yun and Elder Feng behind. Both elders gave Jian Chen a complicated look for a moment, before Elder Feng spoke. Jian Chen, ever since your participation at the gathering of the mercenaries, the young miss has grown quite silent. Sometimes, she has a faraway stare in her eyes. If you have time, please come visit our Huang family. Whatever transpired in the isolated space is something our entire family wishes to know about. Our family leader and patriarch especially wish to thank you. If there is time in the future, I will most certainly come pay a visit. Jian Chen cupped his hands together. Elder Yun let out a sigh of relief before offering an apology. Jian Chen, the matter from a few years ago was our fault. The two of us wish to offer our apologies and hope that you will forgive us. Jian Chen gave a free smile as he spoke. If we speak of that matter, then it was my fault. The unhappiness between Huang Luan and I has been resolved during our time in the isolated space. The two elders needn't worry. Hearing this, both elders had a happy smile on their faces. Jian Chen, my friend, we must return home now, so we bid you goodbye. We will definitely make sure to report this to our patriarch and avoid having Elder Yan Lai make matters worse. Jian Chen laughed as he brought his hands together. Then if the elders could please give Miss Huang Luan my greetings. Ha ha, Jian Chen my friend, these words I will definitely convey to her. One of the elders laughed. In the next moment, they both transformed into two bright light and disappeared into the sky. Watching the two elders go, Jian Chen had no thoughts of retaliating against the Huang family. Not only did he have a connection with Huang Luan, but the Huang family was quite strong in power, and even Jian Chen feared them at this moment. This was because the Huang family had a saint ruler which would pose a problem to Jian Chen. In an instant, Jian Chen's face took on a freezing cold glare as his eyes began to flash with killing intent. Kaiyangan Kingdom, you truly do scheme so sinisterly. Fine, I will play along with you, he muttered. Chapter 469, Retaliation from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Kaiyangan Kingdom, although I was able to obtain the Saint Ruler's skeleton, you have found trouble with me. I no longer need to abide by our earlier agreement. Wait and see. When I have time, I will visit again to merit out fairness. Jian Chen muttered under his breath as he floated in the air. At the same time, he felt worried about the Huang family. Although he had once helped Huang Luan, the skeleton of a saint ruler wasn't beneath the ruler armament in rarity and value. Whether or not the patriarch of the Huang family would trouble him for the skeleton, Jian Chen didn't know. All he knew was that the skeleton was indeed a great boon for the patriarch if he had gotten it. However, as an imperial protector of the Kainhuai kingdom, Jian Chen held a certain amount of power over even the greatest of clans on the continent. Even the patriarch of the Huang family would presumably avoid overstepping his boundaries to deal with Jian Chen. It seems that being able to use the chaotic force is even more important than ever. This way, I will have a weapon to use against those of the Saint Ruler level, Jian Chen muttered in resolute determination. After he returned, he would refine the energy within the Saint Ruler's skeleton straight away. Transforming into a jet of azure and violet light, Jian Chen flew off in the direction of the Jusun Kingdom before ultimately disappearing into the horizon.
At the same time in the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, a single squadron had entered the Imperial Palace. All the guards had knelt on both sides as a polite gesture of welcoming. After several days of traveling, the Second Prince and the Prime Minister had finally returned to the Imperial Palace of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. The very moment they had entered the palace, the travel-weary Second Prince and Prime Minister instantly dismounted from their horses and walked straight for the halls to report to the King. Notified of their arrival to the large halls for a discussion within the palace, the King had sat in his throne. On both sides, 20 armored experts stood without moving, looking more like statues than humans. Each one of them was stony-faced, but their eyes emitted a sharp contrast. The Second Prince and Prime Minister walked into the palace. When they saw the King sitting high above upon his throne, they immediately knelt down in subservience. "Your servant pays his respect to His Majesty. Your child pays his respects to His Majesty." Taking the teacup offered to him by the nearby maid, the King smiled. "Let's skip the formalities. My son, Prime Minister, has our proposal with the Joseon Kingdom gone smoothly?" "Father, the Joseon Kingdom is far too insolent. Not only do they see themselves as higher than everyone else, but they do not even see our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom as above them. Not only did they injure Senior Georgian, we were barely able to escape from the Imperial Palace." The Second Prince immediately told the King what had transpired in the Joseon Kingdom and had added his own details to it to make it seem even worse. Hearing the Second Prince speak, the King's smile slowly began to grow darker and darker until he looked to the Prime Minister and asked slowly, "Prime Minister, is what my son says true? Has the Joseon Kingdom acted in such a way?" "Your Majesty, the Second Prince speaks truly. The Joseon Kingdom has without a doubt placed our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom beneath them. Furthermore, Georgian was indeed injured by them and they were just about to take us in forever." The Prime Minister spoke respectfully. "What bullies they are!" The King roared angrily as his hand slapped the armrest of his throne. "Men, call for Senior Georgian." "Yes." A guard immediately ran off. Quickly, the pale-faced Georgian came running into the hall and knelt before the King. "Are you fine, Georgian?" the King asked in concern. When it came to Heaven Saint Masters, he had to make sure to treat them well. Georgian nodded his head. "Given some time, I will heal." With that, the King listened to Georgian give his explanation. Although there were slight deviations to what the Second Prince and Prime Minister said, the main points were still the same. It was these main points that caused the King of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom to take on a nasty expression. "You there, bring 1,000-year ginseng from my personal collection," the King commanded to one of the palace maids. "Yes, Your Majesty." The maid obeyed before leaving. "Senior Georgian, not too long ago, I received 1,000-year-old ginseng. I present this to you in hopes of a speedy recovery. As for the matter with the Joseon Kingdom, this King will make sure justice is made." When the Joseon Kingdom was mentioned, the King's eyes flashed dangerously. Georgian smiled. "Thank you, Your Majesty, for your concern. However, the one called Qing Ying Xiangshan of the Joseon Kingdom must be treated with care. He is not only a genius among geniuses, but he wields an incredibly powerful energy that can damage the saint weapons of even a Heaven Saint Master. It was because of this power that I was injured. Then there is even more reason to kill him. Otherwise, our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom will have a powerful threat in the future," the King spoke. After Georgian left, the King returned to his throne and looked down at the two subjects still kneeling before him. With a royal air befitting that of the King, he spoke, "Prime Minister Che, have you made certain of the relationship between the Joseon Kingdom and the Kainhuai Kingdom?" "Your Majesty, your servant has investigated the matter. As the King has imagined, the relationship between the two kingdoms isn't close at all." By the time I arrived at the Imperial Palace, the Imperial advisors had already left. After my talks with the Joseon Kingdom's King, I speculate that even the King himself does not know what brought the Kainhuai Kingdom to help them. "HMPH, is that it?" The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's King let out a smile. It seems that our biggest worry would be that Qingyang Xiangshen then, if he was able to become a Heaven Saint Master at such an age and have some sort of powerful ability to damage a Heaven Saint Master's saint weapon, that cannot be let to stand. It is unfortunate that he is not from our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Fine, you two must be tired from your travels. Go and rest up. The rest, I will take care of.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Half a day later, 8 Heaven Saint Masters had been gathered within the depths of the Imperial Palace of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. After talking for an hour, they all left, but 2 additional people had joined their ranks to make a total of 10. 2 days later, the air within the Imperial Palace was different than before. The Black Armors continued to patrol the entire palace while the king himself strolled around it in an extremely pleasant mood. At the current moment, he was playing chess with Yi Ming. He was no longer worried about the future development of the Jisun Kingdom. That was because there was now an incredible strong mountain of a power backing up the entire kingdom. Bang! Suddenly, a large explosion rocked the entire palace, causing it to shudder. A bright red light could be seen as it filled the entire place and sent trouble flying everywhere. Chapter 470, Calamity at the Palace. While playing chess within the garden with Yi Ming, the king was startled to hear an explosive sound ring out. Straight away, the both of them flew up from their seats and looked in the direction of the palace. "What has happened?" the king asked with narrowed eyebrows. When he saw the fiery light flash over the sky, he instantly realized something bad had happened. Yi Ming stared in that direction with confusion for a moment before a change of expression washed over his face. "Not good, there's a mishap going on." With that, Yi Ming's body instantaneously disappeared as he flew toward the palace at high speeds. Right at the location of the palace gates, the previously grand-looking palace walls had crumbled to mere rubble that lay strewn across the ground. About 20 bloody soldiers could be seen unconscious around the rubble, but whether they were alive or not remained to be seen. The azure-colored marble that paved the ground had burned remains from the fierce fire that had flashed over it, making the entire place as hot as the inside of a steamer basket. Above the broken city walls, 10 men wearing different colored clothing could be seen floating 20 meters in the sky. Each one of them were Heaven Saint Masters and observed the sight below them with an icy stare. The commotion in the area caused all of the guards within the palace to come running along with the experts to this part. But whenever someone arrived and saw the 10 experts floating up above them, each one of them grew extremely pale in the face. "Goddamn, those are Heaven Saint Masters. Sound the alarm. The enemies are here!" an Earth Saint Master cried out an order with quivering lips. 10 Saint Masters was a number that the Jisun Kingdom would find hard to repel. Dong, 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 dong. The sounds of several battle drums could be heard soon enough, with their sounds reverberating through the air and throughout the palace. This alarm was the highest level alarm that hadn't been heard for more than a few dozen years. In the case that it was rung, it meant that the palace was in immediate danger of an extremely large threat. It was an alarm that forced everyone to put down whatever they were doing and defend the palace against the enemy. The alarm caused every single soldier and any other expert not yet there to be startled into disbelief. Quickly, they gathered themselves up and immediately headed for the palace gates to see what had happened. A single large source of energy could be felt from within the palace as the water attributed Yi Ming came flying forward. In an instant, he came to a stop right in front of the palace gates. Staring hard at the 10 Heaven Saint Masters, his concentration was focused solely on them and not on the broken rubble beneath him. "Who are you?" Yi Ming asked. Among the 10, a single rich-dressed elder laughed coldly. "We are from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Bring out the princes of the Jisun Kingdom as well as the one called Qingyang Xiangshen right away. It would be best if you don't force us to look for them ourselves. Otherwise, the consequences for your kingdom would be far too dire to accept." "The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom? So you dare to behave so atrociously toward our Jisun Kingdom? You really take us to be a kingdom that is easily bullied?" Yi Ming growled with an extremely serious expression. With there only being a single Heaven Saint Master at the Imperial Palace and the other people strewn about without power, There was no way for the Joseon Kingdom to call on enough strength in such a short amount of time to withstand the 10 Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. You speak correctly. There has been nothing of any importance that our kingdom found to fear from your kingdom. Another red-wearing middle-aged man spoke with a look of disdain. Yi Ming gave a snort. As a single person, he was not afraid of the 10 in front of him. Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, if you don't wish to bring trouble upon your own head, you would do best to retreat. If not, then the Kainhuai Kingdom will not let this matter slide. Do you not understand the connection our two kingdoms have with each other? Pa, you bluff. Don't even bother trying to convince us that your Joseon Kingdom and the Kainhuai Kingdom have some sort of secret connection. We aren't three-year-old children, we cannot be fooled that easily. An elder laughed. They had heard from the King of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom that there was no connection or friendship between the two kingdoms, so they weren't afraid of the power that the Kainhuai Kingdom held. Hurry up and call out the king and his daughter. Otherwise, your Joseon Kingdom's palace will be razed to the ground this very day. A suntanned elder spoke dangerously with eyes that seemed as if they could shoot lightning. By now, the imperial palace had already gathered 1,000 of the finest black armor soldiers. However, when they saw the 10 Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, they were stunned. A Heaven Saint Master was an entity that stood at the very top of the world. They weren't enemies that any one of the Black Armors could contend against. Despite having over 1,000 Black Armors, they were completely powerless in the face of these Heaven Saint Masters. By now, the king had finally appeared with several of the strongest Black Armors from the garden. Upon seeing the 10 floating Heaven Saint Masters, the king had a look of utmost concentration. However, his forward pace hadn't stopped for a moment and continued to walk with his head held high. One of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom noticed the king straight away and began to whisper to his comrades, "Take a look, that's the king of the Joseon Kingdom." The 10 Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom began to look at the king. Then, one of them nodded, "That should be him, let this old man take him." Then, that very same person flew down to the king. "Don't think you will get away with this," Yi Ming roared as he moved to block the elder. Without hesitation, he brought out his saint weapon and sent a furious slash of energy toward the incoming elder. With an icy glare of his own, the elder took out his own saint weapon to block Yi Ming. A battle to be won is a battle that is over quickly. "Bei Lai, let us two help Elder Mo." Another elder immediately brought out his saint weapon to attack Yi Ming. The elder he had been talking to nodded his head and immediately entered the fray, making it a three-on-one battle. The strength of the three Heaven Saint Masters were by no means weaker than Yi Ming. One of the three had actually been a step higher than Yi Ming in strength. With it being one against three, the pressure on Yi Ming was abnormally high. With three people focusing on him, it was very hard to dodge or even retaliate. After all, he was not on the same level of those from the Kainhuai Kingdom or Chang Wuji from the Joseon Kingdom. The four men continued to battle passionately. Each strike of their saint weapons led to a large amount of energy sloughing off of their weapons. It sounded like lightning striking from the ninth layer of the heavens. The large amount of energy was enough for the palace walls to be battered again and again, inflicting several serious blows to them. The imperial palace had already been thrown into disarray from all of this. With over 1,000 of the finest soldiers running amok, they seemed as if the sky above them was sending down a disaster. "Your Highness, please get away from here." The black armors guarding the king immediately gauged that the situation wasn't clearing up and immediately called for the king to escape into the palace depths. They all knew that against 10 Heaven Saint Masters, there was no way for them to stop them. The only solution here was to flee. One of the men from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom instantly noticed the black armors running away with the king. With a sneer, he spoke, "Pa, where do you think you're going? Do you take us as wall decorations and someone to ignore as you run away?" As he spoke, a strong amount of earth attributed saint force wrapped around his body and trailed behind him as he sped toward the king. One of the black armors grew startled and cried out, "They're chasing us. Take his majesty and escape from here. I'll hold them off." "Yes, captain. Take care of yourself.
Captain, several black armors called out with serious faces. Their forward movement toward the palace hadn't stopped for a moment as they continued to escort the king with haste toward the imperial palace through a hidden passageway. The captain of the black armors brought out a brilliantly silver machete and swung it toward the incoming Heaven Saint Master with a large shout. By clan first sword form, Sky Opener, the silver machete instantaneously transformed into a dark green color which then exploded out from the machete's blade with a brilliant resplendent light that filled the sky. The entire world was dyed with a dark green color that shot toward the Heaven Saint Master with blinding speed. At the same time, a heaven-oppressing amount of pressure suddenly filled the entire area. The glow from the machete had locked onto the Heaven Saint Master with a fierce light. To the Heaven Saint Master, the entire area seemed as if it was locking him into a quagmire that made just moving a difficult matter. This is a heaven-tier battle skill. The Heaven Saint Master that was chasing after the king cried out in shock. He had briefly been unable to believe just what had transpired. No matter what he thought of, there was no way he ever would have thought that an Earth Saint Master of the Jisung Kingdom would have a priceless heaven-tier battle skill. What? The captain has a heaven-tier battle skill? Those black armors that had been escorting the king paused for a moment. Their eyes opened wide in shock as they turned to look at their captain in disbelief as well. Up in midair, the news of a heaven-tier battle skill had caught the interest of the remaining six Heaven Saint Masters in the sky above. Each one gave a startled cry as they looked to the black armor's captain that had been using the heaven-tier battle skill to fight. Their eyes held a coveting look that did nothing to hide their desire on wishing to learn the heaven-tier battle skill that the black armor's captain was using. Even the three Heaven Saint Masters fighting against Yi Ming were tempted by the heaven-tier battle skill. The three let out a loud cry while simultaneously landing a single serious blow on Yi Ming. As he let out a mouthful of blood and fell back down to the ground, the three men instantly charged at the Black Armor's captain. The Heaven Saint Master that had been locked in place due to the heaven-tier battle skill let out a cruel smile. I didn't think that a tiny Earth Saint Master would have a heaven-tier battle skill. How unexpected this was. But with your strength, you cannot bring out the entire might of the battle skill. Even if it is a heaven-tier battle skill, it isn't enough to pose a problem to me. Allow me to show you my Earth-tier battle skill then. The Heaven Saint Master's saint weapon began to glow with a fierce earthen glow as he prepared to use his earth-tier battle skill against the heaven-tier battle skill. The two sides collided with a fierce explosion of wind, causing the area around the imperial palace to crack into several large fissures. Although the battle skill from the Bai clan was a heaven-tier battle skill, he was an Earth Saint Master. This meant that the power of his heaven-tier battle skill would be lessened. Unless he was a sixth cycle Earth Saint Master, using a heaven-tier battle skill would not be effective against a Heaven Saint Master. So when the Heaven Saint Master's battle skill struck by Dao's own, the heaven-tier battle skill was instantly dissipated and the earth-tier battle skill struck by Dao in the chest. He immediately spat out a mouthful of blood and flew 100 meters back toward the palace, landing on the ground. Chapter 471, The King Has Been Captured. The Heaven Saint Masters flew toward Bai Dao, flying through the broken palace walls. Then, several of them carried out the heavily injured Bai Dao. The 10 Heaven Saint Masters stared heavily at Bai Dao with undisguised eyes of avaricious greed before one of them began to breath heavily. Hurry, take his space ring out to see if there's the heaven-tier battle skill. The allure of such a battle skill was so much that all 10 of them had briefly forgotten about their mission. Immediately, someone impatiently searched Bai Dao's space ring before rifling through the inner contents of it. After a while, he shook his head with a disappointed look. No good, the heaven-tier battle skill isn't in this space ring. Let me take a look. One man was unwilling to give up. After looking through the space ring for himself, he finally revealed a similar expression to the first man and spoke in disappointment. There really isn't one in here. Afterward, everyone tried their hand at searching the space ring. There was indeed no heaven-tier battle skill. An earth-tier battle skill couldn't even be found within it. Let's take him back with us. We can interrogate him for it later. A crane-haired elder spoke slowly. No matter what methods we use,
We must obtain this battle skill, even if he has to write it out completely for us. A middle-aged man gave his input coldly. If we are able to obtain that heaven-tier battle skill, then our strength will definitely increase by another level. A rather frail-looking person said. The look in his eyes showed an invigorating excitement. Each of the other Heaven Saint Masters had an excited smile on their faces as well. When it came to heaven-tier battle skills, their mouths drooled at the thought of having one. Unless one had some sort of mysteriously strong background support, then even a Heaven Saint Master would find it difficult to have even a single heaven-tier battle skill. Among the 10 of them, not a single one had a heaven-tier battle skill. At the most, the strongest one had an advanced earth-tier battle skill. Crap, the captain has been captured. From not too far away, one of the black armors in charge of protecting the king cried out in shock. There's no use crying about it, we must protect his majesty. The other black armor's soldier whispered harshly to him as he escorted the king further into the palace. Bai Dao is Qing Yang Xiangshan's uncle, there's no way we could allow anything to happen to him. Otherwise, just how would I be able to face him? The king struggled fiercely against his guards, but with his strength, it was useless for him to try. The black armors held on to the king and picked up their pace in a hurry. A single soldier with a black helmet covering his visage spoke in a worried voice, "Your Highness, we are up against 10 strong experts with a force we cannot hope to defend against. To go against them is to go to our deaths. We should first prioritize your life so that we can plan to rescue the captain in the future." The king sighed with a downtrodden expression. The actions of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had caught the Jisung Kingdom completely unprepared. Suddenly, the black armors running in front of them came to a grinding stop as they stared at the area in front of them with a strong concentration. A single middle-aged man could be seen floating 5 meters up in the air as he sneered at them. This was one of the 10 Heaven Saint Masters of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. "With so many of us coming on this mission, if we were to let you escape from right under our nose, just what face would we have when we return?" The middle-aged man spoke calmly, but there was a look of disdain that could be seen in his eyes. The black armors slowly circled around the king and drew out their saint weapons. "On our lives, we will protect his majesty." There was no dread to be seen in their eyes. Almost as if they gave no regards about their own lives, they charged at the Heaven Saint Masters. The middle-aged man's eyes hardened as he spoke. "A group of ants you are, and yet you still act so impudent." With a sudden push of his palms, an abundant amount of energy from the world exploded violently toward the black armors. Bang, 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 dot. After a series of loud bangs, the black armors seemed as if they were struck by gigantic rocks. Each one spat out a large mouthful of blood and flew back through the air. The black armor they wore had already begun to splinter and crack in several different areas. Losing the several bodyguards he had, the king had finally started to feel a little alone. However, his face didn't reveal any fear. Instead, his eyes glared dangerously at the expert from the Heaven Saint Master. "Your Heavenly Eagle Kingdom will pay a heavy price for your actions today. Do you not know just who the captain of the Black Armors are? He is the uncle of the Kine Huai Kingdom's Imperial Protector." "What? The uncle of the Imperial Protector of the Kine Huai Kingdom? Ha 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 ha." The words of the king had caused the middle-aged man to burst into laughter before looking at the king as if he was an idiot. "My dear king of the Jisung Kingdom, you are the ruler of the kingdom, but even you still speak such childish lies? Think about what identity the Imperial Protector of the Kine Huai Kingdom has. Would his uncle be a lowly bodyguard for a lowly king in a lowly kingdom like the Jisung Kingdom? HMPH, you will regret this sooner or later." The king spoke coldly. He knew that this revelation was surprising. He didn't wish to expend any energy explaining if there would be no one to believe him. The middle-aged man slowly walked up to the king's side and put on a fake smile. "Your Majesty, we only wish to invite you as a guest for our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. At the same time, we would like to extend this invitation to your daughter and Qing Yang Xiangshan. You may as well call them out instead of waiting for us to do the retrieving. If we were to take a move, then that would not do well for you." Hearing this,
The king's eyes flashed with an almost undetectable amount of light. Sneering, he spoke, "My daughter and Qingying Xiangshan are no longer within the imperial palace. By now, they've already returned to the Qingying Manor in Lore City. If you are truly courageous, then go capture them at their manor." HMPH. By now, the Jisung Kingdom had only the Qingying clan as a force that could contend against the Ten Heaven Saint Masters. Because of his knowledge, the king knew in his heart that the Qingying clan had seven Heaven Saint Masters watching over it at the moment. Aside from Qingying Xiangshan and Cheng Wuji, whose strength were nearly incomparable, the five imperial advisors from the Kainhuai Kingdom were fully capable of fighting one against two. Right now, both he and Bai Dao were captured. Whether or not they could escape would rely completely on the Qingying clan. The Qingying clan. The middle-aged man let out a snort and a flash of cold light appeared in his eyes. Smiling sinisterly, he said, "We were just on our way to trample the Qingying clan. That makes things convenient. Your Royal Highness, we will be leaving now then." With a single hand, the man carried the king by his clothes and immediately joined with the other nine Heaven Saint Masters. "My friends, I've captured the king of the Jisung Kingdom." The man brought the king right in front of them and laughed. "Where is the princess and Qingying Xiangshan? Those two people must be brought back as well. We cannot be missing anyone," an elder said. The middle-aged man laughed. "The princess and Qingying Xiangshan weren't at the palace. Right now they're at the Qingying clan. It's fortunate that that location was already one of our target locations. There's no time to lose. Let us set off for the manor straight away. However, we must be careful around that Qingying Xiangshan. I've heard Georgian say that he wields a strange and powerful energy that can damage our saint weapons." A red-robed elder spoke from behind with a suspicious expression. "There's no need to worry. I don't believe that he would be able to defend himself against all of us. With so many people, he'll be too overwhelmed to do anything." Afterward, the Ten Heaven Saint Masters brought the king and Bai Dao into the sky, leaving thousands of the Black Armors and the heavily injured Yi Ming to watch in agony as the group of now 12 flew away. News of the king's kidnapping spread far, and soon enough, the entire palace and city had gone into an uproar. Chapter 472, Kicking an Iron Panel. Within the Qingying Manor in Lore City, Qingying Ba and Cheng Wuji were conversing with the five imperial advisors from the Kainhuai Kingdom in a luxurious-looking room. Jian Chen had left several days ago, giving Qingying Ba the time to chat with the five imperial advisors in an attempt to pull them closer together. "Honored five imperial advisors, if living here for the past few days has not been to your liking, or if there is something not satisfactory, then please speak up and we will definitely strive to improve." Qingying Ba spoke with a laugh. Although his own son was the imperial protector of the Kainhuai Kingdom, making the five imperial advisors his subordinates, Qingying Ba did not wish to treat them impolitely. After all, they were still Heaven Saint Masters in the end. "Our host has been far too polite. We five have been very comfortable these past few days." Zhao Tian smiled. Because he was the strongest among the five and was exceptionally talented in his own right, he had become the substitute leader while Jian Chen was away. During their talks, they did not treat Qingying Ba as if he was lower than them despite his strength as an Earth Saint Master. On the contrary, the five of them had treated him with all the respect they could. It was almost as if they feared angering him so that they seemed more like equals. The reason for this, however, was due to his exceptional son. While the men were joyously chatting together, Cheng Wuji's expression suddenly slipped before standing up with a serious expression. Cupping his hands, he spoke, "Honored imperial advisors, my leader, this slave has an urgent matter to attend to." "Cheng Wuji, where are you going in such a hurry?" Qingying Ba laughed as he looked to Cheng Wuji with an eye that regarded him highly. "Cheng Wuji, if you have need for us, then please just instruct us to do so." Zhao Tian laughed as his own eyes secretly looked to the sky outside the room. Cheng Wuji uttered a single word of thanks before leaving the room. Standing outside,
Chang Wuji's face grew solemn as he flew into the sky, the light in his eyes twinkled with some confusion before his own body flew higher and higher into the sky above the Qingyang Manor. A Heaven Saint Master could fly at high speeds. After rushing from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, the 10 Heaven Saint Masters, Bai Dao, and the King of the Jisun Kingdom were already a few several thousand meters away from Lore City. By now, they were on a perfectly straight route for Qingyang Manor. A frail-looking man looked at the map in his hands. "Qingyang Manor is right in front of us," he spoke. "This time our target is the Qingyang clan. They are a minor clan, so let us just annihilate their clan to allow them to know the consequences of offending our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom." A crane-haired elder spoke. He was a member of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's royal family, so he knew of the finer details of the entire matter more than the others. To completely destroy the Qingyang clan was what the King of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had wanted. Hearing this, the King of the Jisun Kingdom had a look of contempt on his face as he was carried by a middle-aged man. In his heart, he thought, "Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, this time you've truly stirred the hornet's nest. No one can save you now." The 10 Heaven Saint Masters quickly arrived right in front of the Qingyang clan, but Chang Wuji could be seen staring at them with both his hands folded against his chest. The men from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had come without disguising their power at all. The very moment they had entered the vicinity of Lore City, Zhao Tian and Chang Wuji had both sensed their presence. Chang Wuji stared grimly at the 10 experts before his eyes fell upon the King of the Jisun Kingdom and the still unconscious Bai Dao. With a startled composure, he cried out, "Your Majesty, you must be the strongest of the Qingyang clan, Chang Wuji." The crane-haired elder spoke with cold eyes and an equally cold voice. With both the King of the Jisun Kingdom and Bai Dao captured, Chang Wuji didn't need to think to know that these 10 were enemies and not friends. "Who are you?" Chang Wuji spoke with a dangerous voice. "We are from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom." "Chang Wuji, have Qingyang Xiangshun get out here right now. After offending our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, he cannot leave from here in peace." The crane-haired elder spoke with a tone that seemed to grow even icier with each word. Chang Wuji's eyes flashed dangerously as a spike of energy began to burst from his body. Glowering at the group in front of him, he spoke, "You from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, to dare speak of the fourth master so disrespectfully, did you wish to die so soon? To speak to us in such a manner, you'll die for this." The same elder's face twisted in anger before charging straight for Chang Wuji with his saint weapon out. Chang Wuji let out an unfearing snort before preparing himself for battle. His own saint weapon appeared in his hand, and at the same time, a surge of saint force began to billow out from within his body in an amount that seemed to exceed his own strength. The waves of energy were so strong that they could be seen rippling through the space around them. For the sake of deterrence, Chang Wuji had immediately used the Heaven's Stolen Fortune to multiply his fighting strength of a fifth cycle Heaven Saint Master by threefold. With this, he had already exceeded the strength of a peak sixth cycle Heaven Saint Master, and if he couldn't split the heavens with a single blow, then he would surely be able to split the mountains and earth. Bang! The two saint weapons collided with a resounding crash. The elder from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom let out a muffled sound as blood splurted from his lips before he was forced to fly away from Chang Wuji. With a single exchange, Chang Wuji had defeated a second cycle Heaven Saint Master. Such a strength like this shocked the other 9 Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. While they did their research on the Qingyang clan earlier and knew of Chang Wuji's strength, they didn't know that he would be that terrifyingly strong. The reason why Chang Wuji had been able to kill any Heaven Saint Masters in the Battle of the Four Kingdoms against the Jisun Kingdom was due to him borrowing the power of a Heaven Tier battle skill. But now, Chang Wuji had been able to injure a second cycle Heaven Saint Master in a single blow. This type of strength had far exceeded any of their expectations. Beneath, the entire Qingyang Manor had been sent into disarray when a large amount of killing intent had flooded the area. But when they all looked up to see the 11 Heaven Saint Masters, their faces instantly slackened and instantly found it hard to swallow their saliva due to their mouths dropping open.
Unhand His Majesty and Bai Dao straight away or face the consequences. Chang Wuji didn't continue to attack and instead stared heavily at the men in front of him. With both the king and Bai Dao captured, Chang Wuji wasn't able to fully attack without fear of hurting the two as a result. Be at ease, Chang Wuji, while I admit that your strength is beyond any one of us in a one-against-one match, but you are only just one man. Combined with Qingyang Xiangshen, there is only two Heaven Saint Masters within the Qingyang clan. Compared to the 10 of us, do you think the two of you have a chance? An elder reasoned. Chang Wuji gave a cold smile. You underestimate our Qingyang clan. Now, release the two immediately. We've still time to talk about this. Otherwise, the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom will become the enemy of our Jisun Kingdom. Your annihilation will be in due time by then. Ha ha ha, what a great joke you know how to spin. Your Jisun Kingdom has no way of destroying our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. The crane-haired elder laughed in disdain. At that moment, the one that flew at Chang Wuji had flown back up. His face was pale, and a hint of fear could be seen in the lights of his eyes. A man wearing a bright red robe with equally red hair spoke, "They are all dead men walking, why waste words and time on them? Have some people deal with Chang Wuji, two others will go search for Qingyang Xiangshen. What a coward for life he is if he doesn't dare to come out." The red-haired elder was a fourth cycle Heaven Saint Master and also the strongest of the group. Within the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, many had already seen him as their leader for the mission that works. Leader Zhu, Patriarch Huang, Elder Mu Bei, and Elder Ping Yun. The five of us will face off against Chang Wuji then. The frail elder laughed. The five of them were third cycle Heaven Saint Masters. With their powers combined, then they would be able to give a sixth cycle Heaven Saint Master a headache. The five elders took a stride forward in midair at the same time, smiling. One of them spoke, "I've heard Chang Wuji has a heaven tier battle skill. We've benefited greatly from the Jisun Kingdom, it seems." At this, the other four men began to talk among themselves for a moment before quickly engaging Chang Wuji into a brawl. "Father!" Suddenly, a frantic cry could be heard from below, only for everyone to see Princess Yu Yu and Bai Yunshan standing beneath them. Their faces had a terrified look as they saw the king within the hands of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Yu Yu's lovely face had already turned pale as she feared what might happen to her father. Seeing his own daughter beneath him, the king's face quavered for a moment before shouting, "Yuer, run away. Run away now." A battle between Heaven Saint Masters could easily injure a large multitude of people, so the king was worried about the potential damage that could occur to her. The father and daughter conversation allowed the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom to confirm that she was the princess. Straight away, two men flew down to the ground to capture her. She was one of the two capture targets. Suddenly, before they could even touch the ground, a strange development had occurred as five figures suddenly flew in at tremendous speeds. A boundless amount of energy could be felt radiating from their bodies with an overwhelming amount of pressure. "What?" The two Heaven Saint Masters cried out in surprise. They never would have expected that the Qingyang clan would have five hidden Heaven Saint Masters. Furthermore, these five Heaven Saint Masters were no weaker than them. Three of them were already far stronger than any of them. The five Heaven Saint Masters from the Kainhuai Kingdom had finally revealed themselves. The five Imperial Advisors hadn't given the two men from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom any time to react. The five of them instantly drew close to the enemy, and together, they quickly delivered multiple blows to the two, causing them to fly back with blood coming out from their mouths. "What? The Qingyang clan still has five Heaven Saint Masters. How is that possible? Since when did the Qingyang clan gain so many? Could all of the experts of the Jisun Kingdom be gathered within Qingyang Manor?" The entire Heavenly Eagle Kingdom was startled, since this had been far beyond their expectations. None of them had thought for a single moment that the Qingyang clan would have any hidden experts, especially people with the same amount of strength that these five Heaven Saint Masters were exuding. This led the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom to feel especially grim, since this new group seemed as if a third cycle Heaven Saint Master was the weakest among their group, and even he wasn't any weaker than Chang Wuji. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom were now all looking extremely grim. At this moment,
The entire group finally thought that they had tried to kick through an iron panel. Chapter 473, Calamity at the Qingyang Clan. Rushing forward, the five imperial advisors quickly rushed toward the two Heaven Saint Masters. Without hesitation, they charged straight for the other three after dealing with the two. How disgraceful. Who was in charge of scouting for information? How does the Qingyang Clan have so many experts? The five men fighting Cheng Wuji had instantly taken note of what happened below. Three of them broke away from the fight to fly toward the five newcomers, while the remaining two continued to fight Cheng Wuji. None of the five imperial advisors spoke a word and instead clashed fiercely with the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Among the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, their strongest Heaven Saint Master was the red-haired elder, who was currently facing off against Zha Tian, while the others faced off against another. The middle-aged man with the King of the Jisung Kingdom handed him over to the other man next to him before saying, "I'll leave the king to you. Look over him while I go lend a hand." The other man took the king and shifted the still unconscious Bai Dao over to his right hand. "Be careful." The first middle-aged man gave a serious nod before taking out his saint weapon to enter the battle. There were a total of 10 Heaven Saint Masters involved in battle now. The battle over the Qingyang Clan would be a strong one. The red-haired fourth cycle Heaven Saint Master continued to exchange several rounds of attacks with Zhao Tian. When the moment came for Zhao Tian to land a single blow on the man's chest, he spat out some blood and the color in his face drained away. Zhao Tian was a fifth cycle Heaven Saint Master and an imperial advisor for the Qinhuai Kingdom. His battle strength far exceeded any other fifth cycle Heaven Saint Master, and it could even be said to be comparable to a sixth cycle Heaven Saint Master. Thus, there was an extremely noticeable difference between the Heaven Saint Master from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom and him. Upon seeing Zhao Tian's strength, the red-haired man had an extremely serious look on his face before he spoke. "The Jisung Kingdom can't possibly have an expert like you. You aren't from around this kingdom, so who are you?" Zhao Tian didn't bother to reply and instead brought his saint weapon toward the red-haired elder with a powerful stroke. In a flash, the red-haired man had no other choice but to block the strike with his own weapon. "Come help me." Stuck in such a precarious situation, the red-haired elder no longer cared for his pride and cried out for assistance. Hearing the red-haired man cry out for help, the other two men turned pale in the face. Their mouths still dripping with blood, they immediately joined in on the fight so that they could fight 3-on-1 against Zhao Tian. These two men had first been responsible for capturing the princess, but they had been immediately wounded by the appearance of the imperial advisors. After they were injured by the five, their strengths were at best 70% of their maximum fighting capacity. Even with them uniting with the red-haired man, they were incapable of defeating Zhao Tian. At most, they would only be able to keep up some sort of balance with difficulty. So another three Heaven Saint Masters had stopped their attack on Cheng Wuji to fight Zhao Tian. His strength wasn't that far away from Zhao Tian's, and after several exchanges, he had already begun to regain the advantage despite being set back earlier, giving the men he was fighting no time to retaliate. There were 10 Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. One of them held both the king and Bai Dao as prisoner, while the other 9 were locked in close combat. Among those 9, Zhao Tian was fighting 3, Cheng Wuji was now fighting 2, and the both of them were winning. The remaining 4 were now locked in close combat with the remaining 4 imperial advisors. King Xiefan, Dong Yi Junbai, Cao Keken, and Tian Luo were 3rd and 4th cycle Heaven Saint Masters. Their strength could compare to Heaven Saint Masters a cycle ahead of them, and combined with their dominating battle strength, they were fully capable of completely suppressing the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom men. Those of the same level of strength would find it a very challenging task to defeat one another in a one-on-one battle. However, the Qinhuai Kingdom was known as one of the 8 Great Powers, a title that was second only to the 3 Great Empires on the Tianyuan continent. To become an imperial advisor, the best of the best had to be chosen. With 15 Heaven Saint Masters doing battle, the fight was a sight to behold. Each exchange and each collision created a tremendous blast with sounds that could be heard from far away. The entire Lore City by this point had ceased its actions,
so every person could stare in the direction of the Qingyang clan in confusion. Even the mercenaries who were eating in a nearby restaurant ran out into the streets or toward the upper levels of the restaurant in order to survey the scene or to discuss with one each other. What happened? Why is there such a tremendous sound now? The sounds are coming from the Qingyang clan. Is there something happening over at their manor? The sounds created from the Heaven Saint Master's battle were tremendous to the point where the entire lower city could hear them. Despite the distance separating the clan and the city, the sounds of battle could be felt by many of the experts. Within the courtyard belonging to a mercenary group, a single robust-looking man quickly walked out from his room as he turned to the sky. What has happened for the world energy to be in such a flux? Could there be several Heaven Saint Masters fighting nearby? Within the courtyards of the other three clans in Lore City, several Earth Saint Master experts had already gathered and stared at the sky in astonishment. The energy of the world had been sent in such a heavy turmoil that even an Earth Saint Master could feel the vibrations. The amount of powerful energy felt in the world was enough to cause any one of them to jump in fright. The fallout that came with this current battle was far more destructive than the fallout that would happen when any regular Heaven Saint Master fought with each other. The flux of world energy is coming from the direction of the Qingyang clan. Is there a war going on over there? The Qingyang clan has the only Heaven Saint Masters in Lore City. What could possibly be happening over there? The men from the three clans began to converse with other Earth Saint Masters in an attempt to guess what was happening. Each one of them was extremely curious and immediately set out in a rush toward the Qingyang clan. Even the city lord of Lore City was startled. With several Earth Saint Masters, he immediately set out on a magical beast's back toward the Qingyang Manor. By now, all of the Earth Saint Masters in Lore City had already guessed several Heaven Saint Masters were partaking in some sort of large battle. They had put a pause to whatever they had initially been doing to run toward the source of the sounds. No matter what was happening at the Qingyang clan, a battle between Heaven Saint Masters was not something to miss. It was an opportunity for them. There was a chance that one of them would be able to comprehend the mysteries of the world wielded by one of the Heaven Saint Masters and make the breakthrough to become a Heaven Saint Master as well. The entire Qingyang Manor had been sent into an uproar already. With over 10 Heaven Saint Masters doing battle, everyone there felt as if they were suffering from a large headache. The entire compound had been sent into disorder with the guards and servants scuttling around. Some of the unluckier men had even been struck by the ripples of energy, killing them violently. Within several moments, there was not a single intact room left within the entire compound. Every single building had received damage equivalent to the entire compound collapsing. Even the pavilion where all the manuals were stored had collapsed, and the 10-meter-tall towers had fallen to pieces as well. Several of the servants who were inside the buildings when they collapsed could be heard screaming out in agony. "My lord, please escape right away." Several bodyguards loyal to Qingyang Ba could be heard right by his side in an attempt to lead him away from the danger. "Madam, please run away." Several other bodyguards were trying to lead the fear-stricken Ling Long away as well. A single burst of fire shot down from the air and made contact with the buildings. With that spark, the entire compound was lit aflame instantly. "Save Maya quickly, he's still in his room." Ling Long immediately bawled as she ran over to one of the combusted rooms. "Protect them, madam, I'll save the young master." One of the captain guards cried out before plunging into the burning room before Qingyang Ba could speak. "Quick, escort the second lady into the cellar." The guards then ushered the startled Yu Fenyan down toward the area with the cellars. At the same time, Bai Yunchen was escorted by her own bodyguards toward the same area. "Fourth lady, it's dangerous outside, please get into the cellar." A guard spoke anxiously, but as he spoke, several rays of sword chi could be seen shooting down from the sky, piercing holes into the ground. Suddenly, the expression on the guard's face froze as blood flowed down his head before he ultimately fell to the ground. Captain, what happened?" The guard escorting Bai Yunchen cried out in anguish before running to where his captain lay on the ground. "There's no time to delay, quickly escort the fourth lady down."
The other guards spoke through their agony and used their own bodies to protect Bai Yunxian as they brought into the protected area. At this moment, another torrent of energy continued to wreak havoc from the sky above. The roof to one of the buildings on the side of Bai Yunxian had begun to lift from the ground and into the direction of Bai Yunxian, causing the guards around her to grow startled. Just at that moment, a cyan glow shot into the scene. The white-robed Ming Dong came into view. With a chop of his sword qi, he split the falling building in two, eliminating the danger. Ming Dong looked to the energy storm above them and turned his head back to look at Bai Yunxian with a solemn look. "I'll lead the way, Zhuge Feng. Aunt Bai's safety will be up to you. Protect Auntie well. If something happens to her, how would we ever face Jian Chen?" Zhuge Feng stood nearby with a vigilant expression. "I will do my best, but a battle of Heaven Saint Masters is far too much for even us. With all that energy being thrown about, even the two of us will have to be extremely careful. Please make sure to look after me as well." "Understood. Please go with them towards the safe area. You should be able to escape from there." Ming Dong immediately began to spearhead a route while Zhuge Feng ran to escort and protect Bai Yunxian from any external dangers. Chapter 474, A Sorry Escape. With Ming Dong and Zhuge Feng acting as two Earth Saint Master bodyguards, Bai Yunxian's safety was at its highest point. The princess was extremely safe right by her side. At that moment, another large wave of energy shot down from the sky. Soon the entire ground was filled with several holes from explosions that sent large pieces of rubble toward Ming Dong and the others. "Careful!" Ming Dong cried out as he ran to protect Bai Yunxian and the princess. The sword in his hand danced as he moved to bring down the stone in front of him. Zhuge Feng himself wielded a giant sword that seemed to dance with flames right by his side. Despite their strengths, there were far too many stones for them to fend off. With the waves of explosion that happened every so often, a finger-sized stone finally broke through their defensive net. With a whistling sound, it shot straight for Bai Yunxian before ultimately leaving behind a small cut that allowed blood to show. "Ah!" A pained cry came from behind Bai Yunxian. Turning around, she could see that the princess was clutching her left shoulder where blood was flowing freely, staining her clothes with a red tint. "Yor, are you all right?" Bai Yunxian ignored her own wound and quickly looked back to the pain-stricken Yu Yu. "I'm fine." Yu Yu spoke, but her pained expression was proof enough that she was enduring a large amount of pain. Seeing Bai Yunxian and Yu Yu sustain an injury, Zhuge Feng and Ming Dong both let show a startled expression. "God damn it!" Ming Dong cursed. "The battle is getting far too rowdy. We can't delay any longer. Hurry into the cellar." Soon after, everyone quickened their pace. The battle in the sky grew more and more intense. While the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom held an advantage with numbers, their strength was beneath the Kainhuai Kingdom's Heaven Saint Master. Thus, the nine Heaven Saint Masters were completely suppressed by the six Heaven Saint Masters to the point where they weren't even able to fight back, forcing them to rely on just their battle skills. All sorts of advanced earth-tier battle skills continued to be thrown about from each of the nine Heaven Saint Masters. Whenever they made contact with the individuals from the Qingyang clan, they would explode with a terrifyingly huge amount of energy that would distort the space around them. With the intensity of the energy, the space seemed like it would split itself apart. Although there was a very noticeable difference between a heaven-tier battle skill and an earth-tier battle skill in terms of power, when a Heaven Saint Master used an earth-tier battle skill, the power from it should not be underestimated, especially when nine Heaven Saint Masters used one at the same time. The amount of power that would overlap each other was tantamount to several heaven-tier battle skills clashing and could shatter the firmaments of the heavens. "Ah!" Suddenly, a cry of agony could be heard, piercing cleanly through the exploding sounds of battle. Turning to look, everyone could see the Heaven Saint Master that was fighting Chang Wuji had his right hand chopped off. The arm flopped to the ground while blood sprayed out of the stump like rain. Chang Wuji's eyes had a thirst for blood in them as he stepped forward without letting the man escape him. With a thundering clap of sound, his sword stabbed straight through the man's chest. "Elder Ping Yun!" The other man fighting Chang Wuji cried out in shock. Charging forward,
He attempted to stab Chang Wuji through the chest as well. With an ice-cold expression, Chang Wuji pulled his sword out from the man's chest and swung his sword with all his might toward the incoming enemy. By himself, how could a third cycle Heaven Saint Master be a match for Chang Wuji? With a single thrust of his sword, Chang Wuji repelled the man. Chang Wuji's face was especially gloomy and a fury radiated from his eyes. There was no way he didn't know what was happening down below him, but with the two men he was fighting annoying him to death, there had been no way for him to go down to save anyone. Chang Wuji's gaze locked onto the chest of the man he had stabbed. With a single step, he flew toward him, and with his sword hand falling downward, he moved to lop off the man's head. Although using a heaven tier battle skill would easily kill his opponent, it would also require a large amount of saint force. Not only that, but the Qingyang clan down below would be hit with the fallout. A heaven tier battle skill would decimate the entire manor. Seeing the sword falling down at a tremendous speed, the man's face fell with shock. First he had lost his right arm, then he had a hole straight through his chest. The two of these two wounds had already brought forth a tremendous amount of damage. He wouldn't even have enough energy to defend himself against another strike, so he opted to fall toward the ground. With a sneer, Chang Wuji's sword tip shot forth 10 meters in an instant. Quickly, the sword came down with an executing slash that bisected the man's head, killing his soul. Thus, the very first individual from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom was killed by Chang Wuji. Elder Ping Yun. A grief-filled voice called out from the man who had been sent flying back from Chang Wuji's earlier blow. Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Today I will ensure that you pay a heavy price for your actions. Chang Wuji exclaimed as he brought his sword flying toward the other man with a swift motion. After seeing Chang Wuji kill someone, the other five Heaven Saint Masters from the Kainhuai Kingdom grew excited. Their movements grew quicker and, in the span of several seconds, the enemy side gained new wounds. Blood spilled from their mouths as their momentum fell like an arrow at the end of its flight. Bang! Suddenly, a splurt of blood could be seen falling through the sky. Zhao Tian's hand had rammed straight into one of the Heaven Saint Masters' head, pulverizing it into a bloody mess. Thus, the second Heaven Saint Master from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had fallen. We can't win, retreat. After having two of their own killed, the remaining few members felt as if they were dealt a tremendous blow. One of the members immediately cried out for the others to give up the fight and to escape. If I let you run away, I, King Xiaoshan, would have no face to return back home. King Xiaoshan sneered. With the wind element enveloping his body, he quickly streamed for one of the escaping fighters. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom men were dominated completely. Although they were able to hold on to their lives, they wouldn't be able to do so for long. Everyone from their group knew when they were over their heads and no longer had the bravado from earlier. Seeing someone else try to run, the others had been hasty not to fall behind and ran away one by one. After a short battle, two of the nine had fallen and the remaining seven had been severely injured. On the other side, no one had taken any heavy injuries and still had energy to spare. Unlike them, the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom's men barely had any energy left to escape. It won't be that easy to get away. All five of the Imperial Advisors gave chase with Zhao Tian leading the group while Chang Wuji stayed behind to check on the Qingyang clan down below. Experts from all over had rushed to this location the moment they heard a battle taking place at the Qingyang clan. They began to observe the intense battle from far away with absolute shock. In the golden age of the Jisun Kingdom, they had no more than 10 Heaven Saint Masters. With Chang Wuji now as the 11th, they were at a number that was greater than the amount of Heaven Saint Masters in their golden age. As for the Qingyang clan, their entire compound had been laid to waste. Every building had collapsed into rubbish, and the bodies of guards and servants could be seen strewn about. Although the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom men had fled, the battle had not yet stopped. The five Imperial Advisors from the Kainhuai Kingdom continued to surprise everyone by chasing the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom men with no mercy. King Xiaoshan possessed the wind-attributed saint force and could use the wind element to increase his speed to become the fastest among the group. In a flash,
He was able to catch up to his adversary and began to unleash his full strength, easily throwing out an advanced Earth-tier battle skill. He chopped off the head of one of the already injured men. The man didn't instantly die from the blow and had hurriedly grabbed at his head before attempting to escape. Killing a Heaven Saint Master would require vanquishing the soul. However, this man who had his head chopped off was weakened. Without any energy to fight, he was ultimately slower than the rest. In an instant, King Xiaoshan caught him and bisected the head in two. By that point, the other four Imperial advisors had already caught up with the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom and forced them into another fierce battle in the sky once more. Energy began to be thrown about, causing heavy damage to the streets and buildings nearby. Countless passers-by cried out in panic as they tried to escape, while some of the unluckier ones were struck by the waves of energy, killing them in a violent manner. In that one moment of warfare, the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom lost another expert by the hands of Zhao Tian. Zhao Tian extinguished the man's soul with a single strike through the eyebrows, allowing his body to fall to the ground and crumple on the streets. The man who was holding both the king and Bai Dao realized that if he didn't take an emergency action here and now, it would be insanely difficult for him to run away. With that in mind, he immediately threw both captives in opposing directions before shouting, "If you wish for the king, then here you have him." The five Imperial advisors had stayed within the Qingyang clan for many days and thus learned many things from their talks with Qingyang Ba. So they knew the identity of these two. One of them was the future father-in-law of their Imperial Protector, the other was the uncle of their Imperial Protector. Both of these men were of high importance, and so there had been no hesitation in what to do next. Straight away, two of the five men broke away to rescue the king and Bai Dao. The one who had thrown the two had not yet ran away. Immediately taking out his saint weapon, he quickly used a mighty Earth-tier battle skill in an attempt to save his comrades. The two Heaven Saint Masters that were not able to run away due to their injuries tried their best to take advantage of the moment where the king and Bai Dao were being rescued. They were able to run away as sorry figures with the assistance of their comrade, forcing the other three to pull back. After several moments, the king and Bai Dao were both safely rescued. The two of them were rather weak and had been in a state of unconsciousness. If they were to hit the ground as they were, it would be a stroke of luck if they didn't die. "We can't let them run away like this," Luo Tian spoke as he looked at the escaping men, his foot itching to give chase. "Stopping Luo Tian," Zhao Tian spoke, "forget that for now. The Imperial Protector won't let this debt go unpaid so easily. For now, our top priority is to return these people back to the Qingyang clan and save the others." "Right, saving them is our top priority. If something were to happen to anyone of importance, then how could we justify ourselves?" Dong Yi Junbai agreed. Afterward, the five Imperial advisors returned to the Qingyang Manor, leaving behind the corpses of the two men from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom on the streets. The fight had not lasted long, and the commotion that had struck Lore City had finally abated. From the 10 Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, in the end, only 6 of them had been able to escape. Chapter 475, The Return of a King. There was not an intact building to be seen throughout the entire compound. It was a complete wreck as far as the eyes could see, with every building collapsed. The corpses of multiple servants and guards could be seen strewn across the grounds. The last expression on their faces had been of anguish. The tragic day that was today would be an unforgettable day for the Qingyang clan. The energy from the 10 Heaven Saint Masters had killed many lives and caused an immeasurable amount of damage. Many more people had been severely injured and left the Qingyang clan in a depressed state. Chang Wuji trod across the broken courtyards with a heavy expression. It was not as heavy as it was during the battle, and he couldn't help but let out a sigh in relief in his heart. Despite the heavy damages the Qingyang clan had incurred, the important figures of the clan hadn't been killed. Some had been injured, but nothing major had happened to them. Chang Wuji walked to the center of the compound and looked all around. With one final sigh, his face descended into grief. The five Imperial advisors from the Qinhuai Kingdom descended next to Chang Wuji. Zhao Tian was the first to speak. "Chang Wuji, how is the clan leader and the fourth lady? Are they injured?"
The five imperial advisors were most concerned with Qing Yangba and Bai Yunshan since they were the parents of the imperial protector. Chang Wuji shook his head. "I thank the imperial advisors for their concern. They both have some minor injuries, nothing too major." Hearing this, the five imperial advisors couldn't help but let out a breath in relief. If one of the two had something happened to them in that short moment, they had no idea how they would be able to face the imperial protector. The secret that the five imperial advisors were living within the Qing Yang clan had been exposed. Everyone that was familiar with what they looked like was extremely astonished the moment they saw the five Heaven Saint Masters retreat into the clan compound. Straight away, discussions could be heard among those people. No one could imagine that the Qing Yang clan would have so many Heaven Saint Master experts hidden within. Such a strength was far too much. "Haha, Senior Chang, Chang Wuji. How is your—" The king coughed out some blood from his internal injuries while struggling to speak. "Your Majesty, please be rest assured, the princess has received no major injuries." Chang Wuji replied, "That's fine, all is fine then." The heart that had leaped into the king's throat had finally fallen back down. Your was his most beloved daughter and thus he was without a doubt concerned for her safety. Afterward, the representatives of the three other clans of Lore City came by personally to express their sympathies to the Qing Yang clan. They had a look of grief in their faces and concern in their voices, but their eyes remained on the five imperial advisors from the Kainhuai Kingdom with feelings of confusion and shock. Many of the members from the three clans had participated within the battle at the Northern Stronghold, so they naturally recognized the imperial advisors. Upon seeing all five of them gathered within the Qing Yang clan and when they helped them fend off the attackers, they couldn't help but feel extremely curious on what connection the two sides had with each other. However, not a single one of them had dared ask why and could only speculate in secret. None of the three clans were in any desire to leave quickly. Instead, they had their men personally help survey the damage to the clan. Despite the entire clan being leveled and destroyed, it did not weaken their reputation or fame. If anything, this had strengthened it. After all, they not only had even more Heaven Saint Masters than before, but they were able to emerge victorious over several experts from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Suddenly, a cyan color burst through the sky, like a lightning bolt, headed toward the Qing Yang clan. In an instant, the light came to a stop and began to hover over it. "Another Heaven Saint Master, how fast this one is." When everyone saw this airborne person, they all let out a startled cry in confusion on whether this was a friend or foe. The five imperial advisors and Chang Wuji both revealed stunned looks on their faces. Turning to look up, their eyes held a dangerous gleam. However, when they saw the facial appearance of the man floating above, a joyous look overcame their faces. "The fourth master has returned, honored imperial protector." This cyan-colored blur had been Jian Chen. After 2 days of constant traveling, he had finally returned to Lore City from the Cave of the Saint Ruler. Jian Chen floated above Qing Yang Manor with a sluggish look. His eyes didn't dare believe the reality of what he was seeing. In the several days when he was gone, the entire Qing Yang clan had undergone a tremendous change. The previously pristine and grand clan compound had disappeared into nothingness. All that remained was a single ruin with thousands of scars and holes as well as bloody bodies strewn about. Is this truly the Qing Yang clan? What has happened? The light in Jian Chen's eyes was quite dull as he muttered to himself in an absent-minded manner. Even the joyous feeling he had felt after receiving the Saint Ruler's skeleton had been completely obliterated. Jian Chen's expression grew more and more dangerous as he descended down to the ground near the ruins. Chang Wuji and the five imperial advisors quickly rushed over to Jian Chen's side, but before they could say anything, Jian Chen spoke first. "Uncle Chang, what has happened here? How did the Qing Yang clan be reduced to such a state?" Jian Chen's voice was filled with concern and his expression with worry. In his recent return, he had no idea just what could possibly happen for the Qing Yang clan to undergo such a tremendous transformation. Chang Wuji let out a long breath of air. "Fourth Master,
10 Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had only just came by with Bai Dao and His Majesty in their grasps. They had spoken some claptrap about capturing you, but after a battle between them and us, the Qingyang clan was inadvertently damaged by the fallout. Hearing this, a sudden explosion of killing intent burst from Jian Chen's body. A fierce glare started to grow brighter and brighter, almost as if he was a bloodthirsty tiger whose stare could cause any person to shiver in fear. The temperature within the immediate area instantly dropped several degrees. Some of the weaker people around them began to feel as if they were submerged within ice-cold water, and they began to shiver. Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Jian Chen spat out one word at a time in his anger as his fist began to crack from being held so tightly. This time, the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had truly infuriated him. Suddenly, a thought crossed Jian Chen's mind. His expression immediately changed as he hurriedly asked, "Uncle Chang, what of my parents? Are they all right?" "The leader and the fourth lady are underground with only minor injuries," Chang Wuji spoke. Before he could finish speaking, Jian Chen had already disappeared into a blur, headed toward the underground rooms. The underground rooms were about 100 meters deep and were very dim. Despite that, it was very spacious and could fit well over 1,000 people in there, with even more rooms to accommodate them all. The very moment Jian Chen entered the rooms below, he could see several of the higher-ranking members of the clan and their guards come walking out. "Fourth Master." Some of the guards instantly saluted him when they saw him. "Where is my mother?" Jian Chen immediately demanded with a dangerous gleam in his eyes, causing the guard to avoid looking him in the eye. "The fourth lady is in the biggest room," the guard answered quickly. He immediately ran past them and into the biggest room in the underground area. However, it would be more appropriate to call these rooms caves instead, due to their appearance. After entering the room, Jian Chen not only found his parents, but even the oldest aunt Ling Long, second aunt Yu Fenyan, and third aunt Bei Yushuang. His third brother Qing Yank was by his mother's side, while several other men covered in blood sat by some of the traumatized women. Right by the entrance, Ming Dong and Zhu Gufeng stood guard. When their eyes met, they didn't need to speak to convey a conversation. "Mother, are you all right?" Jian Chen quickly walked forward with a worried expression. In this moment, Jian Chen looked at the wound on his mother's head with an aghast expression. "Mother, you're hurt." "Xianger, your mother is fine. Go look for Yuer. Her injuries are even worse than mine." Bai Yunchen didn't care for her own injuries, and instead was extremely concerned for her future daughter-in-law. At this moment, the princess lay on a bed with an extremely pale face that was scrunched up in pain. Arriving by the bedside, Jian Chen began to inspect the princess for the extent of her wounds. A solemn expression began to overtake his expression as he made his diagnosis. A stone was lodged in the princess' left shoulder, leaving a finger-sized hole within it. There was also a single wound on the left side of her back from where another stone had struck it. A stone had entered her body and nearly injured her heart. The other inner organs had also been struck, leaving behind a dangerous-looking internal injury. "Xianger, your mother knows you have the ability to heal Yuer. Please save her. She has an extremely dangerous wound," Bai Yunchen whispered to Jian Chen in concern. Afraid that the princess would die from her wounds, Jian Chen nodded. "The battle outside has stopped. Mother, you should go out to check. I'll treat Princess Xu Yu." Bai Yunchen had no objections to that. After a few more words, she left the room, leaving Jian Chen behind with the princess. "Brother, we'll head up first." Ming Dong pulled Zhu Gufeng away from the room. If this was any other time, then Ming Dong would have taken his time to fire question after question to Jian Chen. Ming Dong didn't have the heart to, since such an event happened to the Qingyang clan. After everyone had left, Jian Chen closed the door gingerly behind him and walked back to the bed with a complex expression. With barely a few days of her living in the clan compound, the princess had been heavily injured. This made Jian Chen feel extremely apologetic, almost as if he had personally let her down. Despite the wounds on the princess being quite heavy, she was still awake and capable of clear thought. Her limpid eyes had a strange luster to them as she stared nervously at Jian Chen. Her pale face had a slightly red hue that revealed her shyness. In her heart, despite the troubling moment,
She couldn't help but have a nervous delight from such a situation. Jian Chen sat by her bedside and spoke gently, "Princess Yu Yu, it may be a little painful in the next few moments. Please try to endure." Chapter 476, A Day of Healing. N. Yu Yu slowly closed her eyes and gave a light answer in response. However, she couldn't help but feel slightly disappointed and unhappy from the way Jian Chen had called out to her. Princess Jelin was a name His Majesty had given her, but her real name was Yu Yu. Back in the flower garden at the Imperial Palace, Yu Yu had stated that Jian Chen should call her by her real name. Seeing how Jian Chen was still calling her princess, Yu Yu couldn't help but feel that the connection the two had with each other had suddenly grown even further apart. Jian Chen was naturally unaware of Yu Yu's thoughts. He focused on the wound on her shoulder for a moment before muttering something and looking elsewhere. The wound had already been treated with gauze and several other medicinal herbs. Jian Chen held a pair of scissors in his hand and began to slowly cut away the clothes near Yu Yu's wounds. Following a kaka, the scissors cut a perfect circle in the middle of Yu Yu's luxurious robes. Underneath, Yu Yu's slender white skin could be seen along with the faint pink undergarments she wore. Sensing that Yu Yu's heart had begun to skip a beat, Jian Chen opened his mouth to explain, "Princess Yu Yu, the stone has already entered your body. In order to advance with your healing, I must remove it first." Yu Yu closed her eyes afterward without another word. However, as she lay on the bed, she felt her body grow stiff with anxiety as a cold sensation began to spread into her left shoulder. This made Yu Yu realize that her entire body could be seen in its entirety by this single man. With such a thought, her face began to blush slightly. Ever since birth, she had never allowed a male to see her body. Grabbing some gauze, Jian Chen first cleaned away the leftover blood on Yu Yu's wounds before slowly putting his palm onto the wounds. The very moment Jian Chen's palm made contact with Yu Yu's flesh, the princess gave a start due to the instant sensation of pain that she felt upon contact. Jian Chen sucked in a deep breath as he began to gently touch the flesh. Unlike his facial expression, his heart was not calm. However, after some time, he managed to school his emotions and stare attentively at Yu Yu's wounds. "Princess Yu Yu, I will start to extract the stone. Please endure it for now." N. Yu Yu gave an answer that was no louder than a mosquito's buzzing. Her face was completely red as she refused to look at Jian Chen in a manner typical of a shy woman. After Jian Chen grew calm, the palm that had been touching Yu Yu's shoulder suddenly began to exude an attractive force that caused a pain-filled cry to come from the princess's throat. In the next moment, a bloody stone came flying out from within her body. After the stone had been extracted, blood began to splurt out like a fountain from the wound's hole. Straight away, Jian Chen lifted his left hand and began to gather a ball of milky white light. The brightness of the sphere began to grow brighter and brighter until the light was nearly dazzling to the eyes within a single moment. Even the dim room was completely illuminated by this light. Yu Yu had her eyes closed, but she could sense a sharp ray of light shining through her closed eyelids. In curiosity, she slowly opened her eyes only to see the white light gathered in Jian Chen's hand. At this sight, Yu Yu's beautiful eyes widened in absolute disbelief at what she was seeing. Although she wasn't a Radiant Saint Master, she had seen the Radiant Saint Force many a times as the princess to a kingdom. That pure white glow wasn't something any other technique could replicate. Naturally, it only required a single look to recognize that only a Radiant Saint Master could control the Radiant Saint Force. Jian Chen's hand slowly fell back down to Yu Yu's wounds and began to use the Radiant Saint Force to heal the injuries. By this point, Jian Chen was already a Class 6 Radiant Saint Master with an abnormally strong control over the Radiant Saint Force. His healing abilities were beyond most, so with the wounds caused by the stone being the only matter, it took almost no time before the wound was completely healed up with no scars left. "Qing Yang Xiangshen, you're a Radiant Saint Master." Yu Yu's eyes stared at Jian Chen with a startled heart. Within the Tianyuan continent, it was completely unheard of for a person to have two types of force. Not only was Jian Chen a talented cultivator,
but he was also a high-leveled Radiant Saint Master. Jian Chen had a faint smile on his face as he spoke. Princess Yu Yu, I hope you can keep this as our secret. Yu Yu's eyes continued to hold a strange gleam as she stared at Jian Chen. After a while, she nodded, I will. I won't speak a word of this to anyone. At this moment, Jian Chen's previously spectacular figure had somehow managed to become even more perfect in her eyes. Princess Yu Yu, I will continue to treat the wounds on your back then. Hearing this, Yu Yu hesitated for a moment before at last nodding her head in silence. However, just as she started to roll over, the injuries on her back suddenly flared up, causing her face to pale in pain. You should remain as you are now. Allow me. Jian Chen quickly stopped Yu Yu's movements and helped her turn her body over to inspect her wounds. Jian Chen and Yu Yu continued to remain in the same room with each other for about 2 hours before finally being able to walk out of the room together. Because of Jian Chen's ability as a Class 6 Radiant Saint Master, he was able to bring life back to a man who is on the verge of dying from his inner organs failing on him. Yu Yu's injuries were not as severe, so he was able to completely treat her without as much effort. After changing into a new set of clothes, Yu Yu still exuded a shy air to her. Occasionally, she would sneak amorous glances at Jian Chen in a bashful manner. When the king and Qing Yangba took notice, they couldn't help but smile knowingly. The important figures of the Qing Yang clan and the other representatives of the three clans of Lore City had all gathered in the area. Jian Chen's mother and the other aunts had been taken away by the guards to recover from their wounds, so Jian Chen had not been able to see his own mother. After leaving the underground room, Jian Chen began to revert back to his original mood. Losing the gentle face he displayed underground, Jian Chen walked to Chang Wuji and spoke with a heavy expression. Uncle Chang, just how heavy were our losses? Quite heavy. At least 200 casualties have been reported so far while the wounded are still being accounted for. There are still many guards and servants whose bodies have been buried under the rubble. It will take us some time to excavate them. All of our buildings have been destroyed. Chang Wuji sighed. A flash of killing intent appeared in Jian Chen's eyes. Clenching his fists, Jian Chen's teeth ground together in anger. Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, I will not let this matter stand. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom are truly uncouth. The king showed a dark expression as well. After being captured by the Heaven Saint Masters from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom, he was naturally furious. Fourth Master, the magical beast you were raising has been found. Suddenly, one of the guards came running forward with the snowy white tiger. The cub. Jian Chen's heart skipped a beat in surprise and immediately took the cub from the hands of the soldier to inspect it. Upon inspection, Jian Chen could see that the dust had dyed the tiger's white fur gray, but its eyes were closed shut as it slept in hibernation to digest the heavenly resources. Seeing that the tiger cub was fine, Jian Chen let out a sigh in relief. He hadn't thought of how many dangers that could possibly happen before he left, so he hadn't taken the tiger cub with him. After feeding the cub several heavenly resources, he allowed it to fall asleep so that it would wake up only after Jian Chen had returned. The Qingyang clan must make a swift recovery. Chang Wuji, I entrust this matter to you to make the necessary preparations. Qing Yangba spoke. Yes, this servant understands. Chang Wuji nodded. Hearing this, the eyes of the ruler of Lore City lit up. Master Qing Yang, please entrust the artisans to me. I will ensure that the very best artisans rebuild the Qingyang clan as swiftly as possible. As for the costs for the materials, please leave that to our three clans. Each of the representatives of the three other major clans spoke. The Qingyang clan hadn't lost any strength after this event. Instead, their fame had exploded, especially to the three clans and the city lord. They had been stunned to see the development of the Qingyang clan's strength. With six Heaven Saint Master in their possession, no regular faction could boast of such a feat. Chapter 477, Plans for Revenge. Qing Yangba began to weave several words of polite refusal to the three clans and the city lord. My Qingyang clan truly appreciates your kindness and goodwill, but despite the calamity that has befallen our Qingyang clan, we still have enough strength to rebuild on our own.
"My dear family, why not build the new Qingyang Manor within the Imperial City? This way, our two families will be much closer to each other. Furthermore, this would allow the Qingyang clan to be able to adopt a governmental position with ease." The king of the Jisung Kingdom spoke with an expectant expression. If the power of the Qingyang clan wasn't contained in the Imperial City, then it would be a great loss. If the Qingyang clan were to be rebuilt within the Imperial City, then the strength of the city would be increased by another level. If something like this happened again, then there would be even more experts ready to answer the call. That is, Qingyang Ba began to hesitate. The Qingyang clan's roots ran deep within Lore City, but with the strength and fame of the Qingyang clan now, they would surely become the number one faction within the Imperial City. A result like this would not be a tremendous loss, but at the same time, it would be a major issue if they truly wished to relocate. After all, the reason why the Qingyang clan was in Lore City was due to the patriarch's arrangements. Seeing Qingyang Ba's expression, Chang Wuji's face grew stiff. "My lord, we cannot choose this option. Residing the Qingyang clan in Lore City was the decision of our patriarch. Lore City could be said to be our ancestral home. Just how could we leave it so easily?" Chang Wuji held an especially special position within the Qingyang clan. Although he was not a qualified elder of the clan, even the leader of the clan wouldn't be able to ignore his words. With Chang Wuji's firm opposition, Qingyang Ba could only decide on declining the king's suggestion. The king could only sigh inwardly to himself with disappointment. He had truly wished for the Qingyang clan to be rebuilt within the Imperial City. That way, he would have added a strong addition to his defenses. The servants and several soldiers of the Qingyang clan began to clear away the rubble in the compound while the elders stored books in their space rings to prevent anyone from stealing them. After all the preparations were done, the clan took up residency in several inns for the time being. At the same time, they called all of the artisans and blacksmiths of Lore City to work around the clock. More than 1,000 artisans gathered that night and began to rebuild the Qingyang clan. The king then issued a decree that made many of the nearby cities send their highest quality building materials, so that the Qingyang clan would be able to be constructed with ease. After issuing the decree, the king grew worried with the safety of the imperial palace, so with barely enough time to dress his wounds, the king immediately left to travel back to the palace. However, Jian Chen was worried for the king's safety. Therefore, he had Zhao Tian and King Xiafan accompany the king back. Such an entourage like this would heighten the imperial palace's defenses as well. On the second day, the Qingyang clan used a healthy sum of money to hire several Radiant Saint Masters from the nearby cities, specializing in healing the injuries of others. These Radiant Saint Masters also had plenty of medicines that were powerful in aiding the healing process of the servants and soldiers. The four deceased men from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had their space rings and the items within confiscated for the clan. From within, the Qingyang clan was able to obtain many precious items, monster cores, and money. There had even been several advanced Earth tier battle skills that made up for what had been lost. The management of the reconstruction of the Qingyang clan was monopolized by Chang Wuji. With him in charge, the others were able to relax a little. Within one of the inns, Qingyang Ba, Bai Yunshan, Jian Chen, and Yu Yu were all standing outside an enclosed room. If seen from a crack outside, a faint white light could be seen shining from within the room. The four continued to wait for an hour before the door finally opened. Three white-robed men with pale complexions came walking out of the room exhausted. These three men were Class 4 Radiant Saint Masters from the nearby cities and were the among the seven strongest Radiant Saint Masters in the Jisung Kingdom. When the three middle-aged men came walking outside, they greeted the four. "Fourth Master, my lord, with the combined efforts of us three, the man's injuries have stabilized for the time being. He has already awoken and wishes to see you. I thank you three for your troubles." Qingyang Ba spoke in gratitude before walking into the room along with Jian Chen, his mother, and Yu Yu right behind him. Laying on the bed was the captain of the Black Armors, Bai Dao. However, his previously pitch-black armor had long since been worn down from the many wounds and injuries he had received. Bai Dao had been treated by three Class 4 Radiant Saint Masters, but his wounds had been far too serious. Thus, his wounds were still not fully healed, and his face was still a pale white color. Seeing Jian Chen and the others having no major injuries, Bai Dao let out a sigh in relief before speaking weakly. "How is the situation now?" They naturally understood what Bai Dao meant. "It was fortunate that the five imperial advisors were here. We were able to beat back the men from the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. Furthermore, we were even able to kill four of them while the remaining survivors fled with heavy injuries. However, our Qingyang clan's compound was completely destroyed with at least 380 casualties so far." Bai Dao clenched his fists tightly with a look of hatred. "We must take vengeance for this. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom has been far too unruly. Even the Imperial Palace of the Jisun Kingdom was destroyed by them, and Senior Yi Ming was injured. Their clash is with us. We involved everyone else and put His Majesty in harm's way." Bai Yunshan spoke with guilt. "Mother, this trouble was brought upon us by your son. Please rest assured, your child will definitely take vengeance for us. I will make the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom pay a heavy price for this." Jian Chen growled with a heavy amount of killing intent pouring out from him. Bai Dao gave a look of respect to Jian Chen. "Xiangshan, I entrust this task to you then. What you see fit to do to the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom is up to you. The Jisun Kingdom had only just experienced a war. Thus our military strength is still lacking for now. We cannot afford to mobilize a large-scale attack on the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom." Jian Chen nodded his head solemnly. "I understand, Uncle. I already have a plan to deal with them." "Xiangshan, you must learn to exploit the resources given to you. The Kain Huai Kingdom has seen fit to give you the title of an Imperial Protector because of your talent. In the future, when you have enough strength, perhaps the Kain Huai Kingdom will have more need for you. When that time comes, that's when you exploit an advantage. You should do so and not waste it." Bai Dao spoke feebly, but he was still able to speak as the uncle teaching his nephew. When he looked at Jian Chen with grateful eyes, he thought about what honor the Bai clan had gained with such an outstanding grandson. Since it was his uncle giving guidance, Jian Chen adopted a modest and studious attitude. However, his heart did not accept the teachings. His age was not truly reflected by his expression, and he had experienced more things than Bai Dao had. Whatever Bai Dao thought to be a problem was not one to Jian Chen. With the pale face of Bai Dao, Jian Chen had a genuine look of concern that could not be hidden. Although he was 15 years old by the time he had first known about his uncle, they were still dear family. Bai Dao was the brother of his mother and, no matter what was said, they were family. With a twist of his hand, Jian Chen retrieved a white jade bottle from his space ring. From within, Jian Chen took out two pills and handed them to Bai Dao. "Uncle, these are Radiant Spirit pills. Please use them to heal yourself." Choosing not to refuse it, Bai Dao accepted the pills with a faint smile. "Xiangshan, your uncle will accept these pills then." "What expensive items these are." "I can bet that a Class 5 Radiant Saint Master created these." Jian Chen's heart skipped a beat at Bai Dao's words. "How exactly does one make these pills?" he asked. "Its manufacturing is extremely troublesome. It requires a Class 5 Radiant Saint Master and an alchemist to simultaneously work together to make a Radiant Spirit pill. Other than that, many rare ingredients and supplements must be gathered. It will fail if there is any negligence, meaning making a Radiant Spirit pill is extremely challenging. The higher the ranking of the pill, the more troublesome it is in making it," Bai Dao explained. Jian Chen's eyes lit up as he secretly concluded to himself that he would definitely find a method to create several pills when he had the time. He would definitely need some in the future, like when he needed to heal someone without the usage of the Radiant Saint Force. After leaving his uncle's room, Jian Chen went straight to Jugufeng and Ming Dong. "I will be leaving for a short amount of time. I'll be troubling you with the protection of my family when the time comes." Hearing this, Ming Dong and Jugufeng both remained silent, almost as if they had long since knew about Jian Chen's plan. "Off to the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom?" Ming Dong asked. Jian Chen walked to the window and opened it to stare off at the distant ruins of the Qingyang clan. "No, to the Kain Huaiang Palace." "The Kain Huai Kingdom?" Ming Dong gasped, with Jugufeng immediately guessing Jian Chen's plan. "Brother,
Don't tell me you are planning to.
The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom will be exterminated.
Jian Chen growled. The Heavenly Eagle Kingdom had stabbed at his reverse scale, so Jian Chen would truly wipe the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom off the face of the Tianyuan continent. At the same time, he would set an example for everyone else with the power of the Kainhuai Kingdom. This would too demonstrate the relationship between the Jisung Kingdom and the Kainhuai Kingdom. After leaving Ming Dong's room, Jian Chen called for Dong Yi Junbai, Tian Luo, and Cao Kekan. Would there be any way possible for a space gate to be situated at the Jisung Kingdom?
It is, but if one wants an extremely accurate positioning, then a reactive device must be installed.
Cao Kekan spoke.
Happily, Jian Chen replied, do you know how to create such a thing?
Yes, that's good.
Go 10 kilometers away from Lore City and set one up.
Jian Chen spoke.
Yes, honored Imperial Protector.
Cao Kekan cupped his hands together and left.
After Cao Kekan left, only Jian Chen, Tian Luo, and Dong Yi Junbai were left in the room.
Jian Chen's eyes swept across the two with a serious expression.
Tian Luo, Dong Yi Junbai,
I will return to the Kainhuai Kingdom for a moment.
You will stay here and protect the Qingyang clan from danger for now.
My family especially must be protected.
Honored Imperial Protector, we will use up all our energy to protect the Qingyang clan.
The two replied, standing up from his chair.
Jian Chen looked at the two men solemnly.
The kindness everyone has shown me here today, I, Jian Chen, will definitely remember and will repay everyone for their kindness.
Hearing this, Tian Luo and Dong Yi Junbai were extremely joyous.
The reason why they followed Jian Chen from the Kainhuai Kingdom was to see Jian Chen's skill for themselves.
In their heart, they knew that Jian Chen would attain heights faster than anyone else, so they used this opportunity to draw themselves close.
Jian Chen's words were like a promise that made the two unable to contain their joy.
If we can serve the Imperial Protector, then it would be our honor.
Chapter 478, Returning to Waloran City.
Leaving the inn, Jian Chen flew to the exit of Lore City and headed in the direction of the area where Cao Kekan was fiddling with whatever had to be done 10 kilometers away. Arriving at Cao Kekan's side, Jian Chen asked,
how is it? Did you finish?
Cao Kekan held two fist-sized crystals in his hand.
Burying one crystal deep underground, he handed the other to Jian Chen.
I've just finished.
Honored Imperial Protector, these two crystals share identical energies that cause them to share an amazing connection.
If you bring this crystal to whomever is operating the space gate on the other side, they will be able to coordinate the space gate to lock onto wherever the other crystal is.
However, it would be for the best that you bring the most detailed map you have to better locate the targeted area.
Jian Chen took the crystal from Cao Kekan and began to study it.
It was a sphere-like crystal that sparkled in a way similar to how light would shine through glass.
There was also a strange type of energy swirling within that Jian Chen had never seen before.
Putting the crystal within his space ring, Jian Chen and Cao Kekan left to return to Lore City.
On the second morning, Jian Chen bid farewell to his clan and left the Jisung Kingdom with the White Tiger Cub.
Bai Yunchen had been extremely reluctant to part with her child, but she knew that his task right now was not a simple one.
With tears, she bade farewell to her son.
The second day after Jian Chen had left the Jisung Kingdom, six pale-faced, raggedy Heaven Saint Masters fell back down to the middle of the Imperial Palace of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom. The guards at the palace had instantly recognized their group and saluted them straight away before running off to report to the king.
The six men burst into the palace halls and sat down in their chairs.
Several men had extremely serious faces and sat there without a word, but the depressing aura around them was quite palpable.
Soon enough, the crisp sound of laughter could be heard from outside.
Ha ha ha, I didn't think seniors would be coming back so fast.
I wasn't expecting such speed, but just how would the Jisung Kingdom have any strength to defend themselves from us?
Have you eliminated that youth, Qingyang Xiangshen?
If he doesn't die, then he will one day bring disaster upon our Heavenly Eagle Kingdom.
Laughing, the king of the Heavenly Eagle Kingdom came walking in.
The glittering smile on his face emphasized just how cheerful he was.
But the six men sat there without a word,
Not a single one had answered the king. When the king strode into the halls, he noticed that the atmosphere within the area wasn't right. Looking curiously at the six men seated nearby, he noticed that they were pale in the face and were depressed as well. Immediately, the smile on his face disappeared as his mood dropped. From the expression of the six, the king could roughly guess that the end results had not been at all like he expected. Growing serious, the king spoke, "Honored seniors, just what in the world happened?" One of the six sighed to the sky with a pain-filled look. "This time, we've angered the wrong people. Originally, everything was going as planned. But when the moment came for us to grab Qing Yang Xiangshan at his clan compound, five Heaven Saint Masters came out to fight us. Their power was far too strong. Even together, we were not a match for them. In the end, they killed four of us and forced the rest of us to flee. We even had to throw away our hostages in order to distract our pursuers and escape with our lives." The king was stunned into silence as he listened. His entire body became paralyzed. This type of result was something he simply could not imagine in a thousand years. He never thought that with 10 Heaven Saint Masters sent to the Jisun Kingdom, they would be beaten. Not only that, but four of them had been killed and the rest were lucky to escape. "Your Highness, we suspect that the five Heaven Saint Masters residing within the Qing Yang clan were in fact the five Imperial Advisors from the Kainhuai Kingdom. Only they would have so much strength like that." The red-haired man spoke with difficulty. Hearing this, the king began to tremble in utter disbelief. Could there truly be a connection between the Qing Yang clan and the Kainhuai Kingdom? I can only hope our suspicions are wrong. The red-haired man sighed. In the blink of an eye, many had passed days since Jian Chen had left the Jisun Kingdom. After traveling for so many days, he had finally arrived back at Walorant City. Walorant City was located within the Zuya Kingdom and was the city that Jian Chen had met Ken Zhao. He and Ken Zhao hadn't seen each other for half a year already, so he had begun to miss him. Thus, he would take this chance to go see him first. There had been no noticeable changes to Walorant City since the last time Jian Chen was here. It had been one and the same, and from the moment Jian Chen walked into the city, the area all around him flashed back in his mind to the day when Ming Dong and he first arrived. This caused his expression to be quite absent-minded. Subconsciously, Jian Chen arrived at the giant gates leading to the Tankan clan. He was prepared to walk right in when the guard standing by the side stopped him from getting too close. "Halt, this is the residence of the Tankan clan. Outsiders are not allowed in." The guard spoke in a stale voice as he looked at Jian Chen. Jian Chen looked at the soldiers. They were not the same ones from before, so they wouldn't know him either. After thinking for a moment, Jian Chen decided to speak with them. "I am looking for Qin Zhao. Please send a message to him for me. At this moment, the young master isn't accepting visitors. Come back another day." Jian Chen's eyebrows furrowed together, but just as he was about to speak, a carriage suddenly came traveling forward at high speeds. Right above the carriage was a single banner with the word, "Qin." Quickly, the carriage stopped right in front of the Tankan clan compound. A single white-colored dress-wearing woman with a delicate figure came stepping out of the carriage. Although her face was covered, it did not take much to guess that her appearance befitted that of a woman capable of bringing down a country with her beauty. The woman stepped off the carriage, and the moment she saw Jian Chen, a look of confusion overcame her face. Shortly after, a look of shock overcame her look of confusion and asked, "If I may ask, are you Lord Jian Chen?" The woman's voice was extremely light and was like the singing of a skylark. Jian Chen arrived right in front of the woman and bowed his hands with a smile. "I didn't think I would come across the second lady here. It has been a year since our last meeting. Your beauty has grown much since then." Chapter 479, Tankan Clan. The second lady of the Tankan Clan gently glided forward to Jian Chen and stared at him with a strange light in her beautiful eyes. "Lord Jian Chen is quite the famous person now. The glorious title of the King of Mercenaries has been so gained by Lord Jian Chen." When the two guards heard what the second lady was saying, their faces grew startled. Turning to look at Jian Chen in a whole new light, They began to feel the utmost regret in their hearts, especially the guard that had firmly refused Jian Chen from entering the clan. His face turned utterly pale. "Blast, I didn't think that he would be the king of mercenaries, Jian Chen. Just what words did I use to speak to him with?" Jian Chen cupped his hands together with a smile. "The second lady's words are too serious. This one only received such a title due to luck, that's all." "Lord Jian Chen is truly modest." The second lady's beautiful eyes revealed a faint smiling expression. Looking at Jian Chen with even more admiration, she spoke, "Lord Jian Chen, since you are here at our Tankin clan, please come in and sit for a while. This one was here for such a purpose." Jian Chen smiled pleasantly without an air of arrogance. "Please come in then, my lord." The second lady waved her hand before walking alongside him into the courtyards. As she passed the guards, she gave a reproachful eye to the both of them and commanded, "This is Lord Jian Chen, an honored guest to our Tankin clan. I pray that you won't be so impolite in the future. Now apologize to Lord Jian Chen with haste." Terrified, the two guards immediately knelt on the ground and spoke with panic, "Your servant should die a thousand's death. Please forgive this servant, Lord Jian Chen." The guards knew how far the influence of being the king of mercenaries went. If the Tankin clan were to find out that they had stopped the king of mercenaries from paying a visit and tried to drive him out, the guards were terrified to think just what serious punishment would befall them. Let it be, this was a trivial matter. Best to forget about it. Jian Chen was not one that finagled with every little thing, and what just happened was not something that was out of the ordinary to him. Many major clans had guards with at least some arrogance. Even his Qingyang clan was no different. Jian Chen followed the second lady into the Tankin clan while the news that the king of mercenaries had arrived quickly spread like wildfire through the guards and to the clan leader. So not too long after Jian Chen entered the courtyards, Qin Zhao's father and the other elders came out to personally greet him. "Ha ha ha. We welcome Brother Jian Chen's presence in our Tankin clan. Your presence brings light to my humble abode." The leader of the Tankin clan laughed with a respectful greeting. Right now, Jian Chen's identity was not the same as it was before. With the title of King of Mercenaries, even the leader of the Tankin clan would have to treat him vastly different than he had before. After exchanging several words of greeting with the leader, Jian Chen was provided with warm hospitality in the halls. Meanwhile, the news that he was here continued to spread within the Tankin clan. Several of the other high-ranking members caught wind of his arrival and came running to meet him. Some wished to become friends with him, while the others wished to see the grace of the King of Mercenaries. Within one of the more luxurious rooms of the Tankin clan, the sounds of the grunts of a man and the erotic sounds of a woman could be heard. Just then, a housekeeper suddenly came running in and knocked on the door. "Young master, this servant has just received word that the King of Mercenaries, Jian Chen, has arrived by our Tankin clan." Within the room, Tianju was currently intertwined with a beautiful woman on the bed. Hearing the housekeeper speak, his entire body began to shake and another part of his body grow impotent. "What, Jian Chen is here in our clan compound?" Tianju couldn't help but think back to what happened between he and Jian Chen a year ago, causing his face to turn pale. "Jian Chen came to the Tankin clan, he has to be looking for me." No, I can't stay here." Tianju immediately lost all his drive to continue having sex with the woman under him. Ignoring the bitterness in her voice, he immediately got off the bed and began to dress. "Housekeeper Tian, prepare a carriage. I will leave the city at once. Do not tell this to anyone." At this moment, Jian Chen was talking with the high-ranking members of the Tankin clan. Now that he was the king of mercenaries, the entire Tankin clan had to treat him with the utmost respect. None of them dared act as if he was nothing like they did a year ago, especially the Tian family. For the sake of apologizing for Tianju's misunderstanding with Jian Chen a year ago, they had to be extra sincere. After several exchanges, Jian Chen got to the root of the problem. Facing the leader of the Tankin clan, he spoke, "My lord, I wish to see Qin Zhao. My deepest apologies, but ever since his return from the gathering of the mercenaries,
My son has gone with the grand elder behind closed door cultivation and has not yet returned. The man spoke apologetically, but inwardly, he was pleased. If his son and Jian Chen were to remain close, when the day came for his son to become the leader of the clan, the Dankun clan would earn an extremely strong friend. There were rumors throughout the Tianyu on continent. Whenever there was a new gathering of the mercenaries, if they were able to fully mature, at the very least, they would become a Heaven Saint Master. The rest would usually be able to have a good chance of breaking through to become a saint ruler. Hearing that Ken Zhao wasn't here, Jian Chen had a disappointed look on his face. He had came to the Dankun clan today just for the purpose of seeing him. Afterward, the Dankun clan tried to persuade Jian Chen to stay even longer in hopes that Jian Chen would agree, while also sending men to call back Ken Zhao. Finally, Jian Chen relented and promised that he would stay one more day. However, he declined the clan's attempt to have them recall Ken Zhao back. He had not wished to disturb Ken Zhao's cultivation. Jian Chen was well received within the Dankun clan, and that night, a feast was prepared for Jian Chen. After the feast, Jian Chen was given a luxurious room that was specially prepared for him. At this moment, the cub that had been sleeping around Jian Chen's chest finally awoke. Opening its bright eyes, it began to look around the room before jumping onto Jian Chen's shoulder, using its furry head to rub Jian Chen's cheek. "Little thing, you've finally awoke after so long." Jian Chen laughed as he pet the cub. Feeling the energy within the tiger cub, Jian Chen could sense that the tiger cub was now at the class 3 level. "Mrrrr." The cub gave a mewling sound as it began to sniff at Jian Chen's space ring with its nose. Realizing what the tiger cub was doing, Jian Chen felt some shock. The tiger cub's intelligence had grown by a large amount if it was able to use this way to find the heavenly resources. This cub truly deserves to be called a heavenly tiger god, Jian Chen thought. Taking out some serpentine grass, core lotus flowers, and purple fruit, Jian Chen began to feed them one by one to the white tiger cub. After several heavenly resources were fed, the tiger cub immediately fell back into a meditative sleep. Placing the sleeping tiger cub onto the bed, Jian Chen put the remaining heavenly resources back into his space ring with a worrying glance. "There's not many heavenly resources left. I probably only have enough for it to reach the class 4 level before I run out. I must go find some more sooner or later, or the cub's strength will be stalled," he muttered. The night quickly passed, and on the second morning, Jian Chen took the tiger cub from his room with him to bid farewell to the Dankun clan. On the way through the flower garden, the sounds of a zither could be heard as the second lady of the Dankun clan sat within the center of a pavilion with her instrument. Hearing the emotional sounds of the zither, Jian Chen couldn't help but think back to the heavenly enchantress he had met back in the Holy Lands of Mercenary City. The heavenly enchantress had been magnificent and peerless under the heavens. Her beauty could capture the hearts of even the animals and shame the moon and flowers. The world would lose its splendor. Even Jian Chen couldn't help but sigh in admiration for this once-in-a-generation woman. Jian Chen calmly walked to the pavilion where the second lady was. Upon looking at the zither on the stone desk, his eyes grew shocked. When he saw the heavenly enchantress in the Holy Lands, he had been able to see the zither she had with her. This very zither the second lady of the Dankun clan was using was the exact same one as the heavenly enchantress. This was far too unexpected. Jian Chen hadn't disturbed the second lady and instead stood very still. Soon enough, the ballad the second lady was playing on her zither finished, allowing her to turn around. "Lord Jian Chen, please sit." There was a faint layer of muslin covering her face so that her appearance could not be seen. Without further ado, Jian Chen walked to the seat right in front of the second lady and sat down. The second lady's slender fingers gently brushed the zither's string with a slight melodic sound. Looking to Jian Chen, she spoke, "This woman knows that Lord Jian Chen is not an enthusiast for the zither. So, what might the Lord be doing standing behind this lady then?" Smiling, Jian Chen spoke, "This one had noticed that the second lady's zither and the zither of the heavenly enchantress are the same. I was merely curious and decided to take a closer look. If I disturbed you,
"Then please forgive me." The second lady's eyes reveal where a surprise light enter them. "Has Lord Jian Chen met the heavenly enchantress?"
"I met her by chance in Mercenary City,"
Jian Chen spoke, understanding straight away. The second lady of the Tankin clan spoke, "The Lord has overlooked a detail. This zither of mine is merely a counterfeit version of the zither of the demonic cry. On the outside, the two look exactly the same, but there are many of these fakes. So it's like that. This one was too hasty in my observations." Afterward, Jian Chen spoke several conversational words before finally saying goodbye. "Second lady, today this one will be leaving the Tankin clan. I hope that we will see each other again in the future. Goodbye."
"Is the Lord leaving that quickly?"
Holding the zither in her hands, the second lady began to walk leisurely with Jian Chen in the manner that a well-brought-up lady would act. "This one has an important matter to take care of that cannot be delayed. Thus, I cannot stay for long," Jian Chen replied. After Jian Chen bade farewell to the second lady, Jian Chen left to find the leader of the Tankin clan. Although the Tankin clan leader wished for him to stay even longer, Jian Chen was determined to leave. Nothing would force him to stay any longer, so it was only with regret that the leader bade farewell to Jian Chen. As soon as Jian Chen left the Tankin clan, he went to buy a detailed map of the area at a nearby emporium. Finding the Dazu Kingdom on it, he immediately set off for it. In all of this, he had inadvertently sent Tianju scrambling away from Walorant City in vain. Chapter 480, Return to the Kainhuai Kingdom. The Dazu Kingdom wasn't far from the Tankin clan. After several hours of flight, Jian Chen finally arrived at one of the strongholds of the Dazu Kingdom. In accordance to the map, Jian Chen followed the directions to the Imperial City. After another 4 hours of flight, Jian Chen traveled 3,000 kilometers into the kingdom and finally arrived at the Imperial City. This time, since he was requesting their help and wished to be courteous and respectful, he did not fly straight for the Imperial Palace and instead descended to the ground right in front of the palace gates. There were guards day and night at the Imperial Palace, and the arrival of a Heaven Saint Master shocked everyone and prompted for the head watch to immediately head down to greet Jian Chen respectfully. "Senior, this one is the captain of the 5th Guard Unit. Might this one know the reason for Senior's presence?" As he spoke, the man looked curiously at Jian Chen. When he took note of how young Jian Chen was, the captain couldn't help but feel surprised. After a while, he concluded that Jian Chen must have used some sort of secret to maintain his youthful appearance, allowing his real age to remain hidden. "This one is the Imperial Advisor for the Kainhuai Kingdom. I came here today to your kingdom to pay a visit. Please send a message for me." Jian Chen spoke calmly. Upon hearing that the person in front of him was the Imperial Advisor for the Kainhuai Kingdom, the captain was immediately startled. "Yes, your servant will send one right away. You there, escort Senior into the palace." The captain commanded a person to escort Jian Chen while he himself used some sort of movement technique to disappear into the palace. Whenever a Heaven Saint Master came to pay a visit, it was never for a small matter. The Imperial Advisor of the Kainhuai Kingdom would most definitely have an extremely large matter. So the captain didn't dare be negligent and immediately ran off to report to the king. Within the magnificent palace of the Dazu Kingdom, several beautiful women with plenty of makeup could be seen singing and dancing with barely any clothes covering their pale bodies. Right in front of them was a pure gold table with all sorts of exotic delicacies. The king was a single man in his 50s and wore a golden dragon robe. Sitting right in front of the table, he was currently enjoying the performance in front of him. Just at that moment, a single court eunuch came running in and knelt before the king's side and whispered in his ear. Suddenly, a startled expression overcame the king's face. Turning to look at the court eunuch, he spoke, "What, an Imperial Advisor of the Kainhuai Kingdom is here to pay a visit?"
"Yes, your highness. The captain of the palace guards came to report to me. He would not lie." Standing straight up, the king strode straight for the outside of the halls and spoke,
come with me to greet him and have some people bring the imperial advisor over." Jian Chen had been relocated to one of the more grand-looking palace halls where the king began to warmly receive him. Five white-haired elders came walking into the palace. As soon as they entered and saw Jian Chen, they immediately sat down on some nearby chairs. "Greeting Jian Chen, the king of the Dazhu Kingdom," spoke, "honored imperial advisor from the Kainhuai Kingdom. These are my five imperial advisors." Jian Chen smiled and cupped his hands toward the five. These five were not strangers to him. Last time he was here, they were the ones that he saw when he was with the Tankan clan as they used the space gate to get to Mercenary City. The five imperial advisors did a friendly salute to Jian Chen as well before exchanging several words of greeting. "For the imperial advisor of the Kainhuai Kingdom to come here, this is an honor for our Dazhu Kingdom. But considering this is quite the important manner, if we may, could Sire please show proof of his status?" Jian Chen gave a faint smile. He knew that the opposition would definitely doubt his identity. The Kainhuai Kingdom was too far away from the Dazhu Kingdom. For an imperial advisor to pay a visit to the Dazhu Kingdom, there would definitely be suspicion. Jian Chen took out a purple jade pendant from within his space ring to show to the elder. "Would this item suffice in proof?" The elder took the jade piece from Jian Chen and began to inspect it. It was made of expert craftsmanship and carried the banner of the Kainhuai Kingdom. The word "Kin" was carved in on it, while on the other side was the word "Protect." However, when the elder realized just what material this jade was made from, his eyes lit up in fierce surprise. "This is spirit amethyst." Hearing this, the surrounding four imperial advisors let loose a shocked expression. Naturally, they knew just what spirit amethyst was. It was an extremely rare and high-quality jade, an item that even the nobles wouldn't be able to buy. It is said that the spirit amethysts were made from the purple clouds that gathered within the world. Such an event was extremely rare and could barely be seen on the Tianyuan continent. TL note: purple clouds were said to be something lazy could ride upon. An important cultural thing I can't really explain. Seeing that the token was made from the especially rare spirit amethyst, the imperial advisors were completely convinced that Jian Chen was who he said he was. Inwardly, they were still surprised and thought to themselves, "It is no wonder the Kainhuai Kingdom is one of the eight great empires. Even the imperial advisors are given a medallion made purely from spirit amethyst." They were not from the Kainhuai Kingdom, and they were far too far away for them to know the schematics behind the Kainhuai Kingdom. Little did they know that an imperial advisor from the Kainhuai would only be given a medallion made from a rare type of metal as proof. It was not made from spirit amethyst at all. Neither would an imperial advisor have the word "protect" carved on their medallions. Only five people within the Kainhuai Kingdom were qualified to hold a medallion made from spirit amethyst. Returning the jade back to Jian Chen, the imperial advisor smiled, "Please forgive my earlier curiosity. I hope Senior won't take offense to it." After confirming his identity, everyone began to treat Jian Chen even better than before. After both sides exchanged some words of conversation, Jian Chen moved on to the heart of the matter. "Today I come to your esteemed kingdom to borrow your space gate. Would that be fine with you?" "Yes, yes, of course. Of course it's fine. Our imperial advisors will open it for you at any time you need." The king didn't hesitate to agree to Jian Chen's request. Pausing for a moment, he added, "Our Dazhu Kingdom and the Kainhuai Kingdom may be far away, but I hope that we can become allies in the future. This one hopes that Senior will convey our intentions back to Kainhuai Kingdom." "I will make sure to convey those words," Jian Chen replied to their request. This area was the only territory with a space gate, and Jian Chen had no idea just how often he would need to use this gate, so he would need to ensure that the connection between the two kingdoms wouldn't falter. Afterward, Jian Chen followed the king of the Dazhu Kingdom out to where the space gate was. The space gate had an array overlaid onto it and had a mysterious and complex magic to it. A single imperial advisor took out several class 5 monster cores from his space ring and inserted it into the cavities of the space gate. With enough power, the array began to light up and surge with energy. Finally,
A 3-meter-large door formed. The insides of the door frame warped in a chaotic way.
Imperial Advisor, where might your destination be?
The Imperial Advisors controlling the space gate spoke to Jian Chen, the Kainhuai Kingdom. Taking a look at the map, the Imperial Advisors found the location and swiftly began to manipulate the space gate. In a flash, the space within the space gate began to clear up to form an image of a large range of mountains.
Since we have no markers, we cannot ascertain the location of the Kainhuai Kingdom's location. We will only be able to send you to a rough coordinate.
Although it isn't within the Kainhuai Kingdom's territory, it should be bordering it.
Imperial Advisor, please head on in. The elder controlling the space gate spoke.
I will be sure to come back to give my thanks in the future. Jian Chen spoke before entering the gate. With a single small pacing of his feet, he crossed countless of kilometers. After Jian Chen walked out from the space gate, it disappeared without a trace behind him and returned to its original form. Looking around, Jian Chen could see that he was standing within a flat mountain range with mountains all around. After taking out his map to look at for a while, he immediately began to fly into the general direction of where the sun was. After half a day, Jian Chen finally arrived at the Kainhuai Kingdom's Imperial Palace and descended down. As soon as he touched down, several soldiers with a frightful amount of killing intent came flying over. At the same time, several strong amounts of chi could be felt from within the Kainhuai Kingdom. Soon, several Heaven Saint Masters with a hostile nature came flying out to surround Jian Chen. When they saw just who the newcomer was, their faces were stunned for a moment before cupping their hands together. We pay our respects to the Imperial Protector. At this moment, the soldiers surrounding Jian Chen realized just who he was. Straight away, the killing intent they had exuded disappeared without a trace. Several hundred people began to kneel down right in front of him. We pay our respects to the honored Imperial Protector. These were the soldiers of the elite with strengths beyond the norms. As they all spoke out in unison, it was as if thunder could be heard rumbling throughout the palace. Jian Chen allowed the soldiers to rise before turning to the confused Heaven Saint Masters.
Did something happen for the Kainhuai Kingdom to be this nervous?
Imperial Protector, our palace forbids the usage of flying. Even we must walk to enter the palace. When we saw a person flying into the palace, we had all assumed it was an enemy. One of the Imperial Advisors spoke.
Jian Chen suddenly realized that he had not stayed within the Kainhuai Kingdom for that long, so he didn't know the rules of this land.
You may leave for now.
I've some matters I wish to discuss with the king first.
With that, Jian Chen left the area. Jian Chen spread his presence to cover the entire palace, and soon enough discovered the king to be in his study and rushed in that direction. Although the Kainhuai Palace had strict security with a guard every 3 steps and a patrol every 5, Jian Chen's status as an Imperial Protector was enough for him to walk unimpeded. No one had the desire to stop him, so Jian Chen was able to enter the king's study, where the king was leisurely reading a book at his table.